reporting on satellite radio.
Show's host, Anthony Cumia and Greg Obi.
Controversial team.
And Anthony apologizing for yet another raunchy
comment. Profanity-laced rap. Is this the last straw for the raunchy radio duo?
I have a raging heart on.
Let me tell you something about this radio show you listen to. We are really good.
Yeah, man. We hang out. We gonna be all wet. Yeah, man.
We know when we suck. We know when we're great. But we do like when you say how great we are.
Holy shit. Oh, my good golly.
Hey, look, we're broadcasting again.
But enough of this palaver. Let's get the show on the road.
Enough of this palaver.
Hi. Everybody. Well, another winter storm for the East Coast, right?
Oh, this one's going to be the worst one ever. Oh, batting down the hatches.
Yeah, if you're listening to us in Arizona, bear with us for a minute. We got another winter storm.
Yeah, the East Coast, just getting pummeled.
Well,
I think we're going to get rain.
You think it's going to be mostly a rain event?
I'm thinking rain.
Yeah.
Yeah, wet and look, north and west and south of the area. They always do that. Snow for our area, gonna be a lot of it. And then our area is also west and north, which is, you know, in the woods. But that's what they say. As far as the city goes, and
I like to ski.
Yeah.
And I will drive 2 hours north of here, 2.5 hours north, and it's the same newscast.
That's what it is.
Yeah, and that's our area.
You're listening to the local news when you drive up there and go skiing?
Mm-hmm.
It's the same thing. And then they go, well, the city and Long Island, don't worry about it. It's a rain event.
But it's funny. They go, for our area, 2 feet. So Long Island, for example, might get 2 to 4 inches, and just west of Manhattan...
Yeah.
Could get 2 feet.
2 feet, but then they say...
But that 2 feet is for our area, so now you're a dummy out there in Long Island thinking, oh my God, I'm going to have 2 feet of snow to deal with.
2 feet of snow.
And they want you to think that.
Because that's the way they word it.
Because they want as many people as possible to keep, you know, tuning in for the latest forecast.
Yep. That's how they...
It's all trickery, my friends.
That's how they word it. They say, 2 feet of snow in our area, we'll tell you where. Mm-hmm. And you're like, what? But is that me?
Got a lot of yay puddings this morning already.
Oh, boy.
A lot of yay puddings.
Jesus. I saw a lot of them being tweeted.
Yeah, but, I mean, we're starting this our first Twitter bit officially, I think.
Wow.
And when you fart, you just type yay pudding, and we're going with Y-A-Y.
Yes, it's easier that way.
But I don't want people just saying yay pudding. I mean, really, just do it when you actually fart. And the new thing that's happening in parentheses.
Parentheses.
They're quickly describing it.
Yeah.
Like yesterday, I went yay pudding, outboard motor in parentheses.
Oh, so it gives you a little description of what happened.
Someone wrote yay pudding, pants. Parentheses, SBD.
Silent but deadly.
Exactly. So they're describing them very quickly in parentheses just to make it a little more fun. But don't just type yay pudding if you're not farting. It's for the farters out there.
Yeah, stop it, you poser. Wannabe.
Yeah.
So we got this dumb weather thing, whatever. We'll get through it.
We said 50-mile-an-hour winds later today.
Well, they're calling it a snow... I can't even say the word.
It's a snurricane.
A snurricane.
That's what Montone was calling it.
Our friend John Montone.
I'm here in Midtown with Abdul the Coffee Man. Abdul, what do you think of the storm?
Think it's going to be rain. Going to be rain.
Where did you get your meteorology degree?
I am a New Yorker. I know this rain. Kill infidel. Wait, I mean rain.
Who made you a weatherman?
That's what he says.
Yeah.
He goes, well, it's apparently going to be a snow hurricane. What would you call that?
A mixed bag.
He said mixed bag.
Didn't get the bait, didn't get the setup. And then he goes, well, some people are calling it a snurricane. I'm John Montone. Well,
but no one's calling it snurricane, John.
John Montone is.
John's hoping that the whole world goes with this snurricane word. Stupid John Montone.
No, he is a fun guy. I listen to him every morning.
I mean stupid in a endearing way.
And yes.
That was just pleasantries.
Pleasantries.
That was a really nice example of pleasantries.
Pleasantries.
Stupid John Montone. Snurricane.
But
by
they
ass.
Are.
What does that mean?
It snow means a snow event with huge winds, which I thought was just called a blizzard.
Right.
You know, when you get snow and a lot of wind, it's called a blizzard.
Mm-hmm.
But they're saying, you know, gale force winds.
I'm kind of liking we're having a real winter. Are you sick of it? Who's sick of it? Who's sick of it? You sick of it, Jimmy?
Just because it's affecting travel. I was supposed to leave today at 2:15,
yeah.
Well, and the next earliest flight was 9:45 because it's a fucking. We were afraid the flight's going to get snowed in.
Wait a minute. I'm doing some calculating. Does that mean you have to leave early today?
Oh, it does.
No.
But I don't want to.
But we're going
to
miss you.
I actually really am annoyed that I have to, but, you know, it's fucking
snow. Yeah.
Yeah. You don't even have to be here. Jimmy's such a trooper.
I know.
He doesn't even have to be here, but he says, you know, I'll come in for an hour, hour and a half, and then I got to get an early flight to Cleveland.
I don't look at this like I used to look at jobs. I don't look at a day off. Honestly, don't. There's a day off. It's like I'm getting out of it. I really despise leaving early, unless it's to get blown, which this is not.
Well,
to go to Cleveland.
Could be. What are you doing later?
Okay. Give it a few more years, and you'll understand, and you'll treat this like a job. Killer whale. I mean, should we get right into this?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
This killer whale down in SeaWorld.
Yep, SeaWorld.
Disney, right?
Which
down
which
there
is,
in Florida.
Well, it's a different organization, but, you know.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
SeaWorld.
Yeah, you're right.
SeaWorld's its own entity.
I just figured Disney owned everything by now, but right.
Yeah,
SeaWorld
really.
Is its own entity.
Now, apparently, there's a big ruse going on down there because They seem to call all of their killer whales, they have names, but when they're out there performing, they're all Shamu.
Really?
Yes! And ladies and gentlemen, here comes Shamu! And it's like, no, that's just another killer whale. Like, they have other, they have a few of them.
I always thought I was seeing the big star of the show.
No, Shamu's dead!
Shamu's just like the,
It's like, you know, the generic name.
Is it like Dave Thomas?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, no, but they're...
No, it's like Ronald McDonald.
Ronald McDonald is
so,
a better
you know,
example.
How many different people have played Ronald McDonald over the years?
Gotcha.
And it's not Ronald McDonald unless Ronald McDonald grabbed you and dragged you under and drown you.
That's.
But then this one is Tillicum, which you may remember the name.
Well, you know what? What are you doing?
Bah.
This is dramatic what we're about to tell everybody.
Oh, yes.
And you just jump right into it.
Oh, I know.
No. Not the mainstream media.
Well, that's
the
true.
The listeners do, yes.
Yeah.
Because they've been following us for a very
they
long
remember.
Time. Sorry, Anthony, but to make it a little more dramatic, because the mainstream media will not give you this little tidbit.
Yeah. Well, this killer whale, who goes by the name Shamu, but is really called Tillicum, is responsible for a few deaths.
Mm-hmm.
This woman that was killed... dragged down to the depths of the tank by the killer whale and drowned.
How did that happen, though? She wasn't in the water, right?
There's conflicting reports, depending on who you talk to.
Uh-huh.
Some people say, and this is the SeaWorld people, are saying she fell into the water and was dragged down.
A trainer's going to fall into the water?
Exactly. Nah. Others are saying the whale was being very rambunctious beforehand and came up... grabbed her and dragged her into the water and down to her death.
And other reports say that it got her in the parking lot.
Yeah.
She was getting something out of the trunk of her car, and he snuck up behind her, dressed as an attendant.
Is it?
Yeah, and he fucking sliced her with a blade.
Isn't that great, though, that, you know, you really don't have to worry about that? Like, if you're walking around the streets, you don't have to go like, fuck, a killer whale or a shark can get me.
Do you understand where I'm at? I can shit-talk it.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
Any whale that wants a piece of it, you know where to get me.
Go ahead. Come and get me.
That's why those Jaws movies were just a bunch of pieces of shit.
Well, everyone goes
especially the 3D one where all she had to do was avoid the water and she would be fine.
Just stay away.
But she had to go to the Caribbean, really?
Move to the Midwest. You're fine.
Right.
The shark will never ever get you.
Don't work on a middle of the ocean oil thing.
Yeah. Just don't do it. Go on boats. Don't do it. Just live in Iowa.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. I don't think there's been one shark attack in a cornfield.
No, not one.
But this killer whale definitely has a problem. This woman, dead, dragged to her death. This telecom was involved in another death of a park employee that was telecom and two other killer whales. So ganged up on one of these employees and killed that person. But we can go back a few years. Telecom's first fatality.
One of our most famous stories ever.
Oh, I loved it.
It's a really old bit. But
and this might explain why this whale is so pissed off. A gentleman was found in Telecom's tank. A big a tank that they snooze in, I guess, years ago. Draped, as they say, draped over the whale's body. Dead. Nude. And there were reports that this gentleman was having sex with the whale's blowhole. And what the whale did was they have the potential when they go under, mm-hmm. they clinch their blowhole closed so no water gets in there. And when they come up, it opens up. Reports were the whale clinched down on this guy's dick and probably balls. Booyah!
A-booyah.
A-booyah! And dragged him down to the murky depths by his cock in the blowhole as it was being raped where it breathes.
Are you trying to say that Tillicum never forgot that incident?
Till I come. That is
till
the,
I come.
Yeah.
Right.
With a name like that, how could you not fuck it in this blowhole?
Right.
But that's like the equivalent of just walking down the street and a mosquito jumps on you and holds your face and rapes your nose.
It just fucks your nostril.
It fucked his sinus.
Yeah. It was fucking its nose. And it must have made the whale angry because two more fatalities since that that prevert.
I may have to correct Anthony, although I don't like to.
Yes, sir.
What? I believe the first fatality was a trainer who fell in the water in 91.
Oh.
And that I think that this guy was the second. And
the blowhole fucker was second?
Second. I guess he didn't realize the reputation of this little fellow.
No, it doesn't make any sense.
That's unbelievable.
Maybe the whale just hates fucking tourists with mullets and wants to be in the ocean with his whale friends.
Well, they said Tillicum was a problem.
Yeah, problem. Rambunctious.
Well, yeah, he was a problem because he never forgot his blowhole raping.
Yep. Oh, my God. They're playing Olympic Wii on the news. That's what they do now.
That's good. We got a killer whale that's killing people, but you have to play.
Exactly.
You have to play Wii.
It's nice. Look at how Jill works the Wiimote. That's nice.
And that's John, who... He was the one yesterday kind of going, oh, I can't believe that guy said that to Hannah Storm.
I remember that hand action. Wait a minute.
Yeah, right on. We're getting more news on this killer whale. Drew in Orlando. Drew?
Oh, sorry. I was just finishing up my road jerk after Anthony's hot story.
Yeah, that was hot, wasn't it? Whale fucking?
The actual stories, they got 400 retards down there filming this thing, and some of the folks were standing like right at the point of impact there. So what they're saying is that the girl's hair got caught in the whale's teeth, and he dragged her under and didn't even know she was there. So,
oh, really?
Anheuser-Busch is just trying to cover their ass. I mean, they're going to get sued.
Well, yeah, but they'll pay that bill. That's easy, and I'm sure they'll be doing some Shamu shows by the weekend.
Yeah, yeah, oh yeah. They don't even have to hose it down.
It's already
they
hosed
just,
down.
Shamu goes up and then hits the water, and all the water goes all over. Yeah. Hose down,
hose down, and ready for action.
That's it.
By Saturday, you'll forget there was a tragedy there.
Yeah.
You'll be there with your cameras and video cameras and little kids. And
eating their cotton candy.
Yeah.
Look out if you're in this area. You're going to get a little wet.
You'll have your Shamu trinkets.
That's right.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a big hit for Shamu. Shamu comes out. That's right. Look at that. Now, these animals are called killer whales, but actually that is a misnomer. They are very gentle, very loving creatures. And the name killer whale has put these animals
in harm's way by humans.
As that's going on,
forgetting that this thing killed three people already.
As that's going on, you get a peek of the corner, kneeling a body away.
The fucking stretcher's out. Yeah. The coroner's there. It was a worm.
Yeah. If you'll notice, now this whale is flashing his teeth with a Nike.
Sam. She went to hand it a fish, and it bit her arm off.
Name was Zabiger.
Because Tillicum is on the loose, dressed as a person. He has a funny nose and fake mustache.
And Jimsy's got to be there.
Yeah.
Like, why isn't Jimsy back at the coroner's office doing an autopsy, but he's there?
At the press conference in his members-only jacket outside SeaWorld.
If you see a five-ton person walking around, it could be this whale.
Yes. Sitting in the stands, just telling the people, please move back. It's very dangerous.
The whale's at a punk rock concert.
Abigail, this whale's been giving her codeine and fish.
Codeine.
She may have Anison.
Anison. Yeah.
She has a toothache. He's giving her Anison.
Anison. whale bit my girlfriend's ass off.
He's swimming around my houseboat right now, Sam. Looking for intrigue in action.
Intrigue. There's no coroner that's having intrigue in his life. Stop it, Quincy.
Quincy does, yeah. Well, I didn't know they were all named Shamu, Anthony. That's a very good fun fact today. So, and do they move these killer whales around after they kill somebody? Kind of like they do with the priests?
Yeah, the Catholic Church.
Like the Catholic Church?
They just move them around to a different parish.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, because this whale was somewhere else before it went to SeaWorld. But,
Stephen S. from Bayshore just got a news tease he wants everyone to know about. A killer whale slaughters its trainer. Could it happen in your neighborhood? Mm. Tune in at 11.
We'll tell you where it could happen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if you work at SeaWorld.
Yeah, we could kind of figure that out.
Yeah.
E-Rock.
He's not responsible for this death.
Is he wearing Jesus, black and white shirt?
Yeah, that's why Eric's neck hurts. He had a neck injury. That's what happened. He was thrashing the trainer about in the water. She kneed his neck.
Can we get a makeup artist to make E-Rock into a killer whale for the day? Yeah.
Yes, the makeup artist is called Nature.
E-Rock writes, we will be playing the old bit of Man Fucking Whale and Tank at end of the show.
Ah,
I don't even know if it holds up, but
stick around for that one.
Yeah, till I come.
Yeah.
Although when I made that mistake and said killer come, that's...
Yeah, killer come. Well, killer sure, cum, sure. The killer whale that goes under the ruse name Shamu.
Shamu.
They're saying some people are saying they should let it go, like a free willy kind of thing. Just let it go.
Just don't kill the fucking
back where
thing.
It goes.
I hate when they kill the animals for doing what they're supposed to be doing.
It's called a killer whale.
Right. And if you get that close, you know, you look like a steak to these damn animals.
They don't know any better.
They don't know shit.
They
want to do is shit and eat. That's
people
it.
People think because they do those cute little tricks and they come up and it's like, now the trainer is going to give the whale a little kiss. And they give a little kiss on the mouth, and the whale opens its mouth and does a stupid little backwards swim move thing. Everybody goes, oh, look, it knows what it's doing. It has no idea what it's doing.
No clue.
Going, I want to bite this motherfucker's head off.
You ever swim with the dolphins?
No!
You swim with the dolphins, because they try to make it look like the dolphins know exactly who you are. They want to interact with human beings. But
like
you notice
Flipper.
The trainer is completely controlling everything with those little fishies.
Yeah, the fish.
Making them do things that the dolphin's just doing to eat.
It's all about the little fish.
The dolphin's not actually trying to shake your hand or wave to you. It wants the little fish from the damn trainer.
Doesn't give a shit about you. It's all about the little fishy.
It has no idea you're on the side there, you know, taking in the action.
The little fish and the fucking little hand motion that the trainer makes before it gets the fish.
Yeah.
Then the thing goes, oh, I'm getting a fish. Mm-hmm. It's not sitting there going, oh, this is going to be fun. I'm going to swim with a people person.
Sure.
No.
I don't know what this means. Bruce in North Carolina, help me out. What do you got?
Morning, boys.
Good morning, Bruce.
Hello.
Hey, Bruce. Thanks for calling.
I was just listening to your whale story, and it gives all new meaning of fuck the whales, doesn't it?
No.
Oh, I don't really know what this is. Is this an old reference? What new meaning?
Yeah, there used to be a, you know, fuck the whales, nuke the whales.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Man's listening to himself.
Have fun listening
to
yourself.
So he's thinking maybe the phone didn't really capture their laughter.
Yeah.
Maybe I have to listen on the radio to really hear the guffaws.
Come down to your participating Carvel ice cream dealer where we have Fudgy the Whale. Leg and arm not included.
Right on.
Hey, guy sticks his dick in the cake. He's got to fuck whales. The kids crying at their birthday. Oh, Uncle Paul, get your dick out of the cake.
I can't help it. Fudgy's so cute.
Rich, what's going on?
Hey, what's up, fellas? How you doing?
Pretty good, Hi. Buddy.
The family of the trainer has already said that she died doing what she loved best.
Drowning?
Yeah.
Breathing water into her lungs.
Drowning.
Yeah, that dying, doing what you, that's just ridiculous.
You never hear that from the family of a social worker who was brutally raped and murdered by a black gentleman.
Oh, Jesus. Unless you're the size queen in life.
Yeah, dying, doing something you like is just overrated.
Once heard from a person who drowned and actually came back and asked them what it was like to drown, and they said, felt like going home. Anyone? Come on. What movie?
Oh, I asked what was drowning, and he said it was like going home.
It's like going home, and then at the end he tells him, no, it was the most painful experience ever.
That was Close Encounters.
Yes, exactly. The Prestige.
Yeah, I never saw that
movie. Oh, Prestige. Yeah, and I saw that movie.
Oh,
yeah.
Come over to the Pantage!
Oh, this is really true. I think Mike is onto something.
He tries so very hard.
Mike in Texas. Mike.
Hey, if that trainer just washed her vag a little better, then the poor little whale wouldn't have mistaken her for a tasty treat.
Oh, my goodness. Are you insinuating that she smelled so bad that the whale thought it was a fish? The trainer, Jennifer Aniston. Yes.
Leave her and her stupid pussy alone.
Oh, God.
Mixed feelings about stuff like this, because, like, I really, you feel bad. This woman probably was very, like, loved animals. Was probably very good. And having them in captivity is kind of shitty, but it does make people, like, feel connected to them and love them. So, like, people are outraged when, there's whaling involved. Ooh. It's kind of hard to really figure out how I feel on this. So I probably should have just thought that instead of saying
it. what are you trying to say, for real?
That I feel that these animals should be free. It's a fucking five-ton animal. It's not meant to be entertaining people wearing fucking Jimmy Buffett t-shirts while they applaud. It should be in the ocean eating whatever they eat.
Or how about at the very least they make the tanks a lot larger? Even the tanks they hold them in when they're not performing, you know, kind of behind the scenes, are small spaces.
That's true.
So it's more convenient for the trainers and I don't know, and whatever. But
well,
at the very least, why don't you make their space a little larger?
It's
a lot larger.
It's going to be a problem for us, I'll tell you, because in the future, there aren't going to be any whales. An alien ship's going to come around and send a signal out that a whale has to get back to
Star Trek!
That's goddamn right. Goddamn.
And I hate Star Trek.
That's it.
Although I enjoyed the movie. The new movie, I really, really enjoyed.
Yes.
I really enjoyed that one. let's say hi to Frank in Staten Island. Frank?
Hey, good morning, guys.
Hey there, Frank.
Good. Hey, man, it was just a matter of time before this happened. I don't know why people are so surprised. Think about it. They jump in there with a black wetsuit on, and what's a killer whale's favorite meal?
Seals.
A seal.
Yeah.
The whales know the difference. He didn't think that she was a seal.
Well, I think she was.
I am.
Maybe. Needed glasses.
I think she was just pulled in from the side, and I don't know. Whatever.
You need glasses.
You know what? Let's just summarize. It doesn't matter.
Yeah.
They'll be doing fucking Shamu shows they'll probably have to take today off. It probably kills them that they're taking today off.
Yeah.
And they'll be back at it by tomorrow.
They have to. It's a giant industry. Mm-hmm. What are they going to do? Shut it down?
No, they're not.
Somebody.
You think your life
doing what they love?
You really think your life's important? But they're probably doing shows today.
Yeah.
With like maybe a quick moment of, they won't even do a moment of silence because they don't want to even acknowledge anything bad happens.
Yeah. Saying she died doing saying she died doing what she loves is like saying a fish died doing what it loves when it's in the boat going. You know, when the fish is like just going, yeah. Doing the mouth thing because its gills don't know what to do with air. That's what she did. That's how she died doing what she loved.
When you see the fish flopping around like that, you don't point out and go, nice lungs, dick.
Yeah, nice. You could breathe underwater. They couldn't figure out how to do both.
I go, look, us humans figured it out.
Look at me.
Yeah, we start in the water. Look, we breathe just fine up here on the boat.
Good air. It is amazing how long they could last breathing in air, though. Like, a fish will just sit there for a while doing that stupid mouth thing. And the gills flapping.
Mm.
Do they get any oxygen from that?
My brother's a marine biologist.
Yeah.
I bet you he would say no.
Yeah, that the gills can't pull any oxygen out of the air?
Oh, maybe. Is there? I don't know.
I would think, because it's like they filter the water through their gills and pull the oxygen out of that. We pull it out of the air, but water, wow, that won't do any good. That kind of hurts us.
No, that's not fun.
It should be easy, though. Why can't we just breathe water?
We probably did at one point.
That'd be nice. You just breathe in your lungs, you sit in there, and then your little alveoli sucks the fucking oxygen out of the water. Mm. What's the problem?
Let's go to Psycho Bob. Psycho!
Give it a try. Let's see if it works with E-Rock.
You know what, dude? Oh, wrong Bob.
Psycho!
Psycho Bob.
Good morning, boys.
Hey, it's been a while. What's up, brother?
Hey, I was wondering if anybody had talked to Shamu about this and seen how Shamu feels.
What happened?
Never mind.
He goes, never mind. Please, that didn't happen. That call never took place.
What happened?
He's trying to set us up for a bit. I wonder how Shamu feels.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know. Why don't you tell us?
Yeah.
Why do we have to be the ones always entertaining? How about you do the fucking bit?
Yeah, he's improv master.
Sorry, thanks, Bud Abbott. Fuck are we?
So Shamu's on first, Fudgy the Whale's on second, and Willie's on third, or whatever you got.
You have another guy. Look at this. Johnny Rock from Hilton Head. Johnny Rock.
Good morning, gentlemen. I would like to get a report from Mr. Jesse Ventura. Great. Tony Shook.
Is Greg and Tony Shook. Is there something wrong with people today?
Well, maybe the snow in the Northeast here.
I don't know.
Huh?
People are very odd today.
They really are.
Very odd.
Let's go to Pat in Staten Island. Pat.
Good morning, boys.
Good morning.
Yeah, I hear that on Saturday they're going to have a guest trainer. It's going to be Henry Winkler, and he's jet skiing it now.
That's funny.
That is.
In his leather jacket.
Very good. Was it a shark or a whale, though?
It was a shark, right? Yeah, okay. It was a shark tank.
And
he jumped the shark, or it would be called Jump the Whale.
Bob, oh, true. Bob the trucker. Bob.
Hey there, Bab.
Hey, congratulations, Ope.
Oh, thank you, Bob.
Oh, you're welcome. Hey, I've been to the SeaWorld shows. They bring a kid up out of the audience and let him pet the thing. Can you imagine if that thing would have ate it?
Yeah, every show they do have a little kid thing.
Kid
yeah, and they have cute music, and the kid gets to interact with the killer whale a little bit, and the whole audience goes, "Oh, imagine, if the killer whale grabbed the kid and went under, holy crap, you would get your money's worth at least."
Oh yeah, they should just send it off and get that woman that played Precious to replace Tillicum.
Just put a fin on her back.
And she'll throw fish at her.
Yeah.
Or throw those fucking that fried chicken legs that she was running around with before she vomited. What a fantastic movie. A hoot. A laugh in every scene is my review.
All right, well, that's how we start the show. God, the phones are lit, but I don't know. Whatever. We're going to do other things.
What?
Well, I mean, where do you want to go? This guy thinks he knows about the pool. Sam in Atlanta. Sam.
Yeah, Bubba Boys.
Hey.
Everybody, Jimmy.
The reason that tank is so small is because they're still using the shorter cattle prods that they've used over the years.
Do they cattle
prod? Punch it out.
I don't hit them with cattle prods.
What is going on with these guys today?
They have no idea how to work this subject.
Victor in Baltimore. None. Victor.
Victor.
Hey, good morning, guys.
Hey.
There is a fish that can live out of water for like a day or two. They call it the frankenfish. In Maryland, somebody brought one and set it free because it got too big and they couldn't feed it. And it started infesting ponds and stuff, and it would actually get out of one pond.
It's one that walks.
It walks
on its little fins.
Yeah, we've talked about the frankenfish.
There's
videos online. It's creepy because they could walk right out of the water and walk right into another pond, now infesting that pond.
Doesn't it have like lungs and gills or something?
I don't know the details.
I'm not sure.
All I know is this thing could walk out of the water and does.
It's just frightening.
And I don't know how long it could survive out of the water before
Snakehead?
It needs to get back into the
snakehead. Snakehead fish?
Yes. But I think they do call it frankenfish because it's just...
Thank you. ONA fan in D.C.
Yeah.
It's called a...
Yeah, the videos are online.
It's like a big sperm cell.
It's fucking...
Some Asian woman kicking it.
Great.
God.
Why don't you bring it home and...
What's wrong with you?
Chop it up for lunch.
Why don't you just fix the fucking brakes on your cars and your accelerators?
Yes. Stop being obsessed with the walking fish and make sure the brakes are working.
Take it home, chop it in a blender, eat it, and then do a headstand and shit it out and put it on some sex fucking website. That's pretty much. But pixelate out your pubic hairs, you sick fucking bastards. They are really disturbed.
How the hell did? Oh, okay.
Frankenfish sounds like a sci-fi movie. Dirty Dan, it certainly does.
Steve, the trucker, Steve.
Anthony.
Yes, sir.
I got a question for you. You never cease to amaze me. How the hell did you know that that was called an alveoli?
That's where the transfer of oxygen happens between the very small blood vessels in the lungs and the air pocket, which is the alveoli.
How did you know that?
I don't know. I think I just learned it kind of on like Discovery Channel or something.
Yeah, but we all learn shit, but then we decide not to remember it. For some reason, you remember all the stuff.
Sticks with me. Certain things just stick
bizarre.
In my brain. Other things go away really quickly. Like what the boss says.
All right, thank you, Steve.
Like meetings. When we have meetings, that shit is replaced by just useless information. But the good thing is, the meeting's usually useless information. So, I don't know where to put that.
Ah. Exactly.
Great.
All right, we're gonna cut our losses. The phones are still lit, but we're gonna move on to other things after the break. We got
losses.
We got a taste of our "We Are the World" song.
Ah.
The final song will be what? Available tomorrow?
Yeah. Dropping
tomorrow, Sam.
We're looking at dropping the song tomorrow for tomorrow's show.
Wow.
And the clips you brought me are much better than the clips I had the other day.
Yes, these are actual clips from the song.
Oh, nice.
Although they're the single tracks. So
raw tracks.
Yeah, you'll be able to highlight different singers.
Now, will you hear the music and the singers? Or
no.
These are just isolated vocal tracks?
Just the dry tracks.
Wow, okay. This is like a Linda McCartney kind of a thing when they isolated her tracks. And she sounded like shit.
Precisely.
Great.
All right, we're going to play some of these clips after the break, the We Are the World thing.
Nice.
Also, maybe we'll talk a little hockey. Any of the games last night?
No, I just know the USA won.
All right, we'll do that.
It was 3 o'clock that game started. Like, I was going to fucking sit there and watch a goddamn hockey game at 3 o'clock
in
the afternoon.
Hell yeah.
No, I was busy.
They're saying that was the most exciting game of the Olympics.
Very busy sleeping.
I still think the Canada USA game was more exciting, but yesterday's game was pretty rocky.
Now, what has to happen for Canada to play the US again?
They both just have to win now.
That's it. If they both win
they both win tomorrow
next games, then it becomes like holy shit.
That will be
the game.
Yes.
Wow.
Yes. That's it, I think.
That'll be
sick. I think that's what we're down to. They both just have to win now.
That game I would watch.
And I want that to happen.
Yeah, who doesn't? Well, who else are we playing? Like, who are we playing this time?
We got Finland, right?
Finland?
I think we got Finland and Canada.
We should beat them, right?
Slovakia.
Slovakia. Canada should beat them, right?
I'm thinking.
I'm looking at U.S. Canada.
I'm thinking this is setting up nice for a little rematch.
This could be a nice rematch.
Which I'm definitely scared of because I think Canada outplayed, you know, us.
You know what the United States...
But Ryan Miller was standing on his head.
Standing on his head.
Yeah.
You know what the United States knows how to do?
Hmm.
Bring it.
Ooh.
The U.S. knows how to bring it.
Ooh.
When the pressure's on like that. All right, maybe there were more shots on goal last time, and the goalie there, Miller, was standing on his head,
mm-hmm.
apparently. I didn't see the game. But
Miller was definitely standing on his head.
That must have been a sight to see.
And Hiller was standing on his head.
Hiller and Miller.
Well, it was a law firm. They had to remind us that it sounded like a law firm yesterday.
Did they go,
you had Hiller in goal for the dirty fucking Swiss.
Yeah.
And you had Miller and you had Miller in goal for the good old U.S. of A.
We want to apologize to any lawyers that were offended by our lawyer joke that we made.
They made the joke way too many times. Sounds like a law firm. Hiller and Miller.
Hiller and Miller. A puck would come up and fucking crack his skull open.
Yeah, but Hiller had well over 40 saves.
Yeah.
I mean, we barely, you know, squeaked by the dirty Swiss.
But let me tell you, like I said, bring it.
Eh?
It has already been brought in.
And, you know, it's going to be a good game today, but you're going to laugh. But women's hockey, they're playing for the gold today, and it is U.S. versus Canada.
Really?
I'm telling you.
Does anyone care though? Because it's
they hate each
hockey.
Other. Yes, yes.
Is there gonna do they check each other with their tits
tomorrow?
Do they bang their tits against each other?
They're animals, actually. Tomorrow, I guarantee people will call and go, "Holy shit! Did you see that game?"
Because I've actually seen
the teams hate each other.
They don't look
with.
Like women because they got the equipment on and stuff. They really don't look like women.
They look like NHL players from like the late 70s.
With the Ron Duguay hair.
They look like they could have played in the late 70s in the NHL. That's the skill level I think they're sort of up
skill
to.
Skill level?
Yes.
Do they goon it up at all?
You're not really allowed to fight.
Yeah? Like kick them in the pussy?
They're not allowed to fight, which is kind of good because it makes them hit harder. Because they really want to get their aggression out by just knocking someone over the boards.
So they do hit?
Oh, yeah. I've been impressed with the women's hockey in the Olympics. I get beat up by saying that, but it's pretty impressive.
One whole team just trying to sync up all of their periods for the big game. That would be great. They're all just syncing up their periods.
Can you imagine you lose the gold because everyone is on their period?
Everyone's on the rag and just fucking the other team up. There's just blood all over the ice and no one's cut. They just got to keep coming out and cleaning the ice. They don't know why.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought it was the red line. What happened?
That's fucking good, man. Let me go to Matt here. Matt in Toronto.
Opie, I'm with you 100%. I want to see a Canada-US rematch. Yeah. And I think you guys are in tough. You want to talk about bring it, Anthony?
Yes.
Look at what Canada did to the Russians last night. We blew...
Just
them.
Stop with we blew.
They,
all right. It's the United States, USA. We bring it. Not fucking stupid Ruskies.
I'm flying out tomorrow to see the last three games, and I will call you guys.
Hope you crash.
There'll be a party in Monday
Sorry,
morning,
Jim.
And I will be on the phone
You're flying.
Celebrating.
Well, I mean... Yeah, I mean, Russia, Anthony, had a really good team, and Canada did beat them. What was the final score? 8-2, I believe.
It doesn't matter. Don't you understand?
8-2.
This is destiny. This is destiny for the United States.
What are you, trying to start your own sports curse?
That's what I'm doing. No, I just, I know this.
Be quiet.
USA.
Let's be quiet on this one.
Number one. We are the bestest. I know. It is. Destined for greatness.
Oh yeah, this is a little fun fact for you, Brian in Cleveland. Brian,
hey guys, how's it going?
Good, Brian.
Good. There's twin girls that play for the U.S. hockey team. They're both blonde, smoking hot, and they have matching tattoos. They're fucking ridiculous.
What?
Yep.
Punch that up.
Yep.
Come on, young Samuel.
No clue what their names are because they're bitches that play hockey. So who cares?
And you know what?
They're really hot.
I don't know their names either. You're right, but I bet you they look hot. But if you saw them out of their hockey gear, they're probably a bit on the large side.
Let me see.
Jimmy, can't wait to see you tomorrow night, guys. Punching out.
Oh, you're going to see Jimmy at the House of Blues in Cleveland.
Absolutely. I've seen him four times now.
kills it every time.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, man. Make sure you see Jimmy. Jimmy's going out of his way to try to get to Cleveland. He's leaving the show early to beat the weather out. So the least you guys could do is make sure you go see Jimmy at the House of Blues in Cleveland.
I moonwalk at the end.
Oh. I want to see that part.
What do you think, Ant?
It's just the blonde hair that's making him look kind of good.
Yeah, that's
put some crooked fucking taped glasses on him, and they're the Hanson brothers. I really am not feeling it with these two. Hey, for female hockey players, based on that, fucking tens. Oh, geez, look how frumpy. They're hunched over.
Oof.
No.
Well, the one,
no.
One on the right's not bad.
The one on the right is not bad because the one on the left is awful.
Wow, man. You know what? Because in their hockey gear, they kind of look all right, but yeah, you put them in normal clothes and
yeah, their bodies are too weirdly athletic. They're hunched over, like I guess because you know you got to get hold that stick and hunch over a little bit, so they have horrible posture, and they have like strong bodies and little boobies.
You bring up a good point, Ant. I work out a lot, right? And I'm in the gym the other day.
Oh yeah,
these goddamn women are catching up to us men.
Is that
I actually saw a woman doing men push-ups.
Really?
Yes.
That's like seeing a guy do girly push-ups.
Well, the women all throughout the years have done the girl push-up, which is you just have to you keep your knees on the floor.
Yeah.
Not anymore,
you keep
man.
Keep your knees on the floor, bitch.
Not anymore.
That's what I say.
Not anymore.
Oh.
There's something going on out there. The women are starting to do fucking men push-ups. What's that about?
They want to catch up.
Well, the evolution, they're getting close.
I don't know. I like a nice shapely girl, but
women don't understand that anymore. They have to go to the gym and look like men now.
I'm not into the rock hard fucking, you know. I don't want to run my hand over a chick's ass and feel like, you know, Schwarzenegger circa 75. You know, I like a nice fucking curved.
You need a little softness.
Soft.
I'm with you.
It's wonderful.
You don't want Madonna.
No.
Like Madonna's arms and stuff.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. It's like fucking running your hand over a chicken wing, a raw chicken wing. All you're feeling is cartilage, bone, and ligament. Who needs that?
Yeah, you're right.
You know, you want a girl with some nice, little bit of meat on her. Or at least smooth, soft, not anorexic, but just nice.
And this guy's going to make me look like a fool, but it has to happen. Colonel in Georgia.
Hey, Gregory, I want to call you out. Women's hockey, no checking allowed. Sorry.
I've seen a couple of games. Then what the hell are they doing instead of checking?
No checking. Say, excuse me, may I have the puck, please?
Huh?
They're afraid of the boobies getting hurt, so no checking allowed.
No, is that why?
Can't be why.
I see some rough play, so what are they doing then?
Absolutely no checking. Checking's a 2 minutes. Sit in the sin bin.
That's dumb. Let them fucking check. Let them beat the shit out of each other, man.
Girls hate each other. It would be great.
Girls hate each other way more than guys hate each other.
Oh, yes. If they check each other, they have to sit in the penalty cock.
Yes. Fucking dildo on the seat.
Thank you for that, Colonel.
Why?
Sit on that bitch.
Hey, this guy has something. Joe in Cleveland. Joe?
Chlamydia?
Yeah, baby.
Hey. What's up,
Joe? How are you doing?
Pretty good, man.
Happy birthday, Jimmy.
Oh,
I love you guys. A long-time listener. I call a couple times.
Oh, my God. Sir. This guy's just useless.
I know, completely useless. Yeah. Actually, the real point of this conversation is that I don't have tickets to see Jimmy at House of Blues because every time he comes to Cleveland, it sells out in about a minute and a half. And there's some single seats up in the nosebleed, and then my girlfriend and I can't even sit next to each other. So it is.
She just tells you that, sir, because she doesn't want to sit next to you.
It is true. Unfortunately, I'm the one looking for the tickets while I'm at work all the goddamn day.
Oh, you want tickets for Jim Norton show?
Dude, I would love tickets for Jim Norton.
Saw that one coming.
We're going to give you a taste of the We Are the World song after this break.
Can't wait.
Opie and Anthony and Jim Norton for a little while longer. Stay there. Anyone?
Spirit in the sky. It sounds very 80s. Got that 80s sound to it.
Muse.
What?
Are you into Muse?
Oh, I've heard of them, yes.
They're fucking great, actually. They're playing the Garden, I think. I would love to get some of those guys on the show, but that ain't happening. No. Are we going to get cop-out guys or not?
Oh, no.
Yes.
What's Kevin Smith saying? Is he going to just surprise us and walk in one day?
Saying
after an all-nighter?
I have a hit movie.
With Warner Brothers, and I got to kind of make believe I'm not friends with you guys for a while.
I have a hit movie with a giant fucking movie company.
When are we going to get respect?
I don't think Kevin's like Kevin's like, when you talk to him, you saw that. He's like, he's so happy to see it. There's nothing phony about Kevin.
No, I'm not.
It's really weird.
Yeah, I'm not saying there's any issues at all. I think it's a political thing, because I don't think he's doing our show. And he's done our show many, many times, and he's got this big movie coming out Friday that's going to do very, very well. And we just want to say hi to our pal. Maybe talk a little Olympic hockey. His boy Brodeur is still in it, although he sat yesterday.
Loves the hockey.
Yeah, he loves the hockey. Kevin Smith, thumbs up, thumbs down?
Thumbs
kind of like...
I really don't know. Like, normally these guys are easy enough to get a hold. Thank you.
Tell him to come in, and we'll just make believe it's somebody else. Because we just want to hang out with him.
Kevin, Sean, William Scott, I've always been able to get a hold of them personally and always get responses. And up until the end of last week, they were both coming in. And then the responses stopped.
Yay.
God, our reputation just sucks out there.
I wonder if they're only doing Warner Brothers approved publicity.
I'm thinking our reputation just blows. What do we have to do? What do we have to do less of?
How about yay pudding?
You know, and if I really thought that's all it would take, then I would stop yay pudding tomorrow.
But, it isn't.
But I think our reputation is still just really based on the older version of this show.
It is. We have a rep.
I really
and it
do.
Doesn't go away.
I really believe it's more based on the Sex for Sam and all that stuff. Girls bleeding and running out of buildings naked. You know, that type of thing. But we haven't done that in almost a decade.
I know.
But there's still publicists who remember that
That's
shit.
What I'm thinking.
Yeah, and there's interviews that may not have gone well even 5 years ago whose and those publicists are still involved with these people and these companies. And that's who controls these press schedules. And they see Opie and Anthony on the schedule and they just cross it off.
They go,
and there's nobody speaking for the show. Not that Steve doesn't, but I mean, nobody who talks their language speaking to them going, "No, you guys, this is what happened." There's nobody speaking for the show.
Yeah, well, we got Bob Bully
would be better off speaking for the show.
No confidence in Bob.
It's not that I have no confidence, but Bob can't talk to publicists. They don't know who he is, and they don't give a fuck about him.
That doesn't even fit the job description. Jesus.
Yeah.
It's got to be, somebody.
What? I sent you guys an email.
I know, I got that.
Oh, I know.
Oh, yeah.
I know.
I got that one.
I got it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Good idea. Very good.
Need somebody talking to them in there.
Beep, bada beep, bada boop. One talks to the other. Bada beep, bada boop, bada boop,
bada boop, bada boop, bada beep. Who wants to talk?
I think we just need an explanation because we've known Kevin for so long, and I think we would understand just about any explanation. The only one we wouldn't understand is, well, I actually now hate you fucking guys.
Right. Aww.
But I don't think that's the case.
I don't think that's it.
So I just want an explanation, even if it's a behind-the-scenes explanation.
He's busy, too. He's probably sleeping. I mean, that guy's been going at a ridiculous pace getting this movie done and getting it out. I just snoozing. He knows it's good, so he doesn't have to run around like an idiot fucking chimp.
No, but
trying to get his movie.
He comes in out of his way when he has nothing to promote. That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah.
So if he's in New York, he just likes doing the show, and we like having him on. We'd like to see him in his overcoat walking down that hall.
Well, yeah.
We just would like to do that.
If I was him, I'd be sleeping, going, I got a great movie that's opening tomorrow.
Yeah, but
fuck
then,
everyone.
But
I'm
then,
sleeping.
But then he's going to fly back to L.A., and then we don't see him for a while.
This is what a nice dude he is. We saw him the other night, and my girlfriend didn't want to meet anybody but him. He was the only guy. She's like, I got to get a picture with Kevin Smith. She didn't want not Bruce Willis, only him. So she meets him, and there's a dude, he's surrounded by people. And he talks, and they take a photo, and he's chatty. He's very nice. But 10 minutes later, I get a text from him. He goes, oh, tell your girl, I'm sorry, I'm not always that distracted. But I was just like hoping that he didn't come off as... I'm like, dude, it didn't even sound like that. But it's like, he really is not a guy who loses touch with the people he's friends with. It was. I think Warner Brothers just sets it up, and he might even be back in L.A. at this point. I don't know if he's even in New York.
Yeah, all right. If you get some info, let us know there, Steve. Thank you. Anthony.
But if I get a hold of that motherfucker, I like talking shit.
And Sean William Scott loves doing the show, so I think it might be a Warner Brothers thing. Something's going on. It's obvious something's going on. I just want
to
know.
Do you think they have to do, and I should probably know this, but I don't. I wonder if they have to do only studio-approved publicity. Like, I wonder if studio says,
studio goes, here's what you're doing.
We set up the press, and you do the press that we give you, and that's it.
And that's it, right.
I would like to know, that's all.
I bet that is the case.
Hey, Anthony, John Montone, you brought this to everyone's attention. He's trying
to come up with a
new word called snurricane, right? Yeah. Snurricane.
Yeah.
I guess we got a big storm moving into the New York City area. I don't know. It's probably going to be more of a bust for New York City and Long Island, but west of the city and north of the city, it's going to be a disaster.
They're still preaching six to eight inches for the city.
Okay.
A little less out of Long Island. But, oh, my God, north, west, south, oh, look out. It's insanity.
And 15-mile-an-hour winds, hence the term snurricane that John Montone is really trying to get popular. And we got a little clip of John Montone for the people.
With time to waste as we await the arrival of this monster storm steaming up from the south, New Yorkers have come up with names for the combination snow with hurricane winds. Snurricane has emerged as the favorite, and one Latin American fellow called it Tormenta. And Tony, who's out here hawking umbrellas, knows that...
It's going to be crazy. I know they said it's going to be a crazy storm today.
Crazy.
Crazy.
That much is true. John Montone, 1010 wins, out in the rain.
Yeah, in the rain.
What a waste of time that was.
Was the guy spinning the umbrella? Selling them? Because you know who started that.
What?
Jerry.
Seinfeld?
Of course. He's doing my spin. Funny episode. What are you going to do?
I don't.
It's fucking fantastic.
I don't think I saw that
one. Every fucking episode.
There are still a bunch of episodes I've just never have seen.
Great.
I'm trying to catch up now that it's been, 10 years? That it's been off the air.
Yeah, that it's been off the air.
His ex is writing a book, by the way.
Really? Tell all about his small pee-pee?
Because she saw that he's doing... I want to know what Seinfeld's packing. I'm curious. He's either 4.5 or 9. He's got to be 9 because he's so confident. But he's doing the marriage ref, and she saw that, and she's like, that's a joke because he would never marry me. Like so she's now coming out and trying to use his marriage ref that he's producing to kind of... I guess push her book.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's really doing.
And what, do they go out for a summer or something?
No, 8 years. From 85 8 years? To like 93.
Oh, wow.
But it's like he's married. He's been married for 10 years.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck.
Good for her. Whatever. Everyone's trying to make their fucking dime.
Dude, do you know how many people are going to crawl out of the woodwork if I ever hit, like, iconic status? Do you understand the amount of people that will contribute?
Oh, God.
Not long. Just like one chapter each.
Yes.
Ugh, the humiliation. I don't care. Write it up, you horse. Get your fucking little heads together and put it down on paper.
Too good.
Horse.
too good.
Well, Daddy.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
And he pretended he didn't know.
Old thick back.
We got a taste of the We Are the World song that Troy and Sam and a few other people have been working on behind the scenes, Anthony.
Yeah.
The full song will be on the show tomorrow, right?
Fingers crossed.
So,
but you
fingers
guys,
crossed. I was hearing it's going to be done.
I'm quite confident. We've been doing a lot of work on it. It's all recorded. It was all laid out yesterday. It's in the final mixing stages.
Ah.
Mixing, tuning.
Yeah, just kind of fine-tuning, getting it all
tweaking.
Perfect tweaking, right?
And it features all the people you know, love, and hate from this radio show.
Now, these are the raw tracks.
Yeah, oh yeah.
That's what we're talking. This is with the music eliminated.
Mm-hmm. And all just the effects and all that.
Now,
right?
Normally, the person hears the music in their headphones when you're laying down your track. And you sing along in the mic. And to you, it sounds like, you know, I'm hearing the music and I'm singing. But now the recording is got all this separate,
mm-hmm.
so you can mix it, you know, separate from the music. So you take these tracks and isolate them without the music, and you got yourself a genuine clusterfuck.
It's been driving Troy out of his mind because, like, he produces real music and is, like, an audio guy.
Yeah.
And so he's, like, you know, trying to make everything perfect, and I keep telling him, no, just leave it alone, and it's driving him insane because he's trying to make it.
Tell him don't fucking lose sleep over it.
Yeah.
Don't worry, trying to make this sound good.
It's not going to.
It's the thought that counts.
Well,
Haiti. No idea what this has to do with Haiti.
We got a taste here. We got Kenny attempting the chorus, and he might have screwed up here.
All right.
We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter day, so let's start giving. There's a choice we're making. It's true. I fucked it up.
What a dope.
That's one take Kenny.
Is that good old one take Kenny?
Oh, I thought he was talking about everything in life. I fucked it up.
And then Mustard is part of the song, so we got a little taste of how Mustard is sounding.
Yes, Mustard is the one guy who's like trying to sound really good.
Yeah, he's trying.
Like, yeah,
with the affectation on his voice and the whole deal.
Just what my hands saving our own lives. It's true, and I got out of day. Just you and me. We are the world. We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving. Let's start giving. There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true. We make a better day. Just you and me.
It's not bad.
No,
why
it's
you guys
actually
making faces?
Because I don't like the
grab your lunch out of the dumpster.
The affectation.
Yeah, yeah.
But he actually did sound good there.
Steve from Bay Shore sounds like he's singing with an anvil on his chest. There is kind of a.
But you got a good version of Mustard. He wasn't all fucked up, right?
No, Mustard was sober, and he's actually very concerned because after Troy explained what happened with his album on the air,
yeah,
a lot of fans started contacting him and telling him how bad he fucked everything up.
Yeah.
And so he's like,
oh, shit, yo.
Good, he should.
He's really trying to make an effort. He says he's not going to bring that guy that he brought with him back, and,
yeah,
he's going to come in clean. And he was sober when he did that.
I'm still in, man. I want to, like, help him out and try to get this album out there. But the first session with Troy was a disaster.
Yeah.
It really was. And then he comes in for the We Are the World recordings, and he was sober and sounded really good.
He was way easier to work for. I was worried that he wouldn't want to work with all the non-professionals.
I have an idea.
Yeah.
Is it possible?
No.
You're right. First of all, most artists don't get a chance to be told they're fucking up. Like, they usually just fuck up and that's it. At least he's got a chance. Is there any way, we very much wanted to see Grey Wolf.
Yes.
That you could take Mustard and get an extra verse out of him. And somehow combine him and Grey Wolf and perhaps get a fucking song.
That could be something maybe we add to the album.
Two homeless guys singing a song.
But see, the problem is we can't get Grey Wolf to redo what he did, so we would have to use what Grey Wolf did already.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Because we've already tried to get Grey Wolf to reenact what he did, and it's just not happening.
You get him to get...
Because that goddamn Grey Wolf song, I'll say it every time, that thing is... That's a masterpiece.
It's a minute short of a classic.
Oh, we were so close to a big fucking
hit. That's all right. You try to maybe get or have him and fucking Mustard do something together and then see if you can blend it in or just get Mustard. There's a way to do that where you could probably get something out of it.
Drew Boogie is screaming at his radio right now.
Why?
Because he tried to get some more out of Grey Wolf. He couldn't get anything out of him.
Well, try again.
He spent a whole day in a studio with the guy.
And what was Grey Wolf not doing? Just not sounding good or... Was Mal Teeth in the way? What happened?
I think he wasn't sounding right, and he kept insisting on playing the flute.
Yeah, it's just
it's just
nonsense.
Prima Donna.
It's just nonsense with
Madonna homeless
guys.
It's a flute slash weapon.
That's why they're homeless, by the way.
Yeah.
They're not good at taking direction and shit like that.
Well, we should rip the flute out of his hand and beat him to death. Oh, sounds
that
right.
Be? Treat yourself. That's why you step on cakes.
Yeah. Let's say hi to Bud the Trucker. Exactly. Bud.
Congratulations, Jimmy. You're going to make a great father. This is terrific for Mustard. He's trying to make this piece of shit sound good, but he won't get off the toilet for his own career.
True. Well, trying to make this piece of shit sound good.
That's true, but it's his own stuff, and he falls asleep with a log hanging out like a fucking oxtail.
this piece of shit We Are the World thing that we'll play like three times and then throw away.
Ah, shit.
You're right. And his fucking CD could be out there for a real long time to come. Dash in Syracuse. Dash.
Oh, yeah. Boys.
Hey, Dash.
Hello.
I got a birthday announcement for you.
Yeah.
Daniel Benoit was featured today here on Channel 9 in Syracuse.
No way. Oh, my. See, that would be Chris Benoit's son. That is no longer with us. And he was wished a happy birthday on the local news in Syracuse? Does anyone have that audio that they could send to us?
Who was wishing him a birthday?
It was all the crew, basically. Sam got in on this one, too. So he
Jesus. Oh, no. That's just fucking...
I'm a piece of shit, but even I am uncomfortable with that.
That is really
bad. We're very uncomfortable with it, but we certainly got to hear how
although
it sounded.
Although we were fine with Connor Peterson's birthday announcement.
Yeah, it's true.
Because he was never really out of the womb until, after.
He didn't catch a crippler crossface.
Well, there is a reference to the phone cord in there, too, so...
Oh, no.
Oh, boy.
How did they get that in?
Oh, we have our ways.
Oh, you're part of it.
Oh, well.
Are you part of it?
All right, Dad.
Maybe.
Possibly.
All right, well, how do we get a copy of this? You'll send it to somebody?
Just sent it to Steve at foundrymusic.com.
Yes, we'll have it on in 2 months. Yes, you'll be right behind the giant logo.
Once he gets the comma of his eyes, he can look at his inbox.
That's funny.
I now own your creativity.
Yes.
Large capital inbox looking. Okay, boo.
The inboxer, as I like to call it, my anus. Yeah. I'm going to continue sending you messages saying you have a private message on Foundry. No spam filter will stop me.
All right, Dash. We'll have that on the air in a few minutes. Thank you for all you do.
Enjoy.
You sick fucks.
Yes.
Dash in Syracuse.
We'll have to see that one. That sounds fun.
One more. We have a lot of these raw tracks from the We Are the World recordings, but we'll play one more now, and then we'll play a few more later. We'll break it up.
Pepper them through the show.
We'll break them up a little bit. You might know this person from the show.
Oh,
that's all I'm going to say right now.
We had a world. Some people as children. We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's give something, flashlight to something to make it brighter.
Oh, shit. Did that make the song?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
But that was also, that's one of the things that we have to work out in mixing because Paul Hargis and Chip Chipperson.
Yes.
All changed the lyrics during the chorus.
So that's kind of,
that's driving Troy nuts, right?
Everything, so they may get actually raised in
bring
the
mix. Bring them up in the mix and bring the chorus down a little bit, so you feature these stars.
They ad-libbed a little bit.
I, by the way, was laughing my ass off last night at the fire hydrant factory. fire hydrant factory or something? Or something.
So I wasn't sure.
Fire hydrant factory.
We would have done, be happy in no way.
Of course he would. That's what I was laughing so hard, Jim.
Sure. unless you made him a, something like a castle out of milk bones or something.
Let's show Omega Saturday. We are the ones. We are the children. We are the one of everybody. Just Omega.
Right. Fuck, what are you doing?
You're getting annoyed.
Holy shit.
Mustard's starting to...
Maybe it sounds good on the plastered walls of a shelter, but holy fuck.
Jesus, Anthony.
Enough.
Trying to help a guy.
We're the Charles Omega. We're saving our lives. True, we'll make a better day for you and me.
Fuck. Stop it.
You're turning the corner on Mustard.
Fuck, oh, I'm done.
You had it.
Done. Put it down. Bring in ketchup. I've had enough with Mustard.
Why have you had it?
Back to the fucking shelter with you. Holy shit, that affectation, that affected technique.
He's trying to show people that he's very talented. Even though it's a shit project he's involved with.
We are the one you made a brighter day. Let's talk in trust we make right. We're saving our own life. True, we make a better day. Just you and me.
Hey!
You're making me uncomfortable.
Oh, I hate it. What the fuck?
What's wrong with you?
Let's be behind Dunkin' Donuts and get some breakfast.
Trust we make right. Saving our own lives. Yeah. It's true and I go out a day. Just you and me.
My. Who's my?
We are the world. We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's start giving. Let's start giving. There's a choice we're making.
Yeah. Roof over your head or no roof over your head. You made the wrong one.
Just you and me.
Why are you turning on Mustard?
That's actually not bad. Fuck.
Why are you turning on Mustard?
I just and I. We are the world. We are the world. We are the children. We are the one to make a brighter day. So let's talk it all inside. There's a chance for Omega. We're saving our own life. It's true. Well, I'm about to die. Just you and me. Shit.
Are you saying enough?
Oh, back to the gutter. Back to Skid Row.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
Stop it already.
When Ant has had it, he's had it.
Oh, I have had it. Go fight someone for a heating grate.
You don't even have a hint of a heart.
Oh, God. Enough. Just fucking find yourself a sleeping bag, a heating grate, and a box. I hear him inside. It's coming out of that box. Sounds coming from a box. Made the wrong one, didn't you?
Jesus, happened. Anthony.
Right.
This guy's down on his luck.
Fuck. Oof. Oh, here he is.
Saving our it's true and I go out a day. Just you and me.
My.
We are the world. We are the world.
We are the world.
We are the children. We are the ones who make a brighter day. So let's talk it. So let's talk it. There's a choice we make. We're saving our own lives. And to make a better day. Just you and me.
Shut it! Fuck! Hate it.
Jesus, man.
I don't know. And it is. It's a goof song. Who cares? It's fucking singing it like it's the Star Spangled Banner. It's the fucking fucking seahorse song.
You got that down in three takes. You perfectly had that.
I fucking love it. What am I kidding?
Saving our lives. It's true. Like a battle die. Just you and me. We are the world. We are the world. We are the children.
We are the children.
We are the ones. So let's not give up. Let's not give up. There's a choice we make now. I have seen it all out. It's jumping back up on our Twitter. Doing my...
Right? That fucking rat nest beard? Enough! Holy shit.
Well, he lives on the streets, you know.
Obviously.
Where the fuck do you shave a beard?
Obviously.
Like that?
Please put that in the song, by the way.
The next fucking superstar right there. There he is.
Let's say hi to Mike in New Orleans. Mike?
Mike?
Good morning, boys. Hey, is it just me or does Mustard sound like Dave Matthews if he had boxes crammed full of dry feces?
I don't know what Dave Matthews sounds like. I really don't.
Really?
Watch it out, boy.
You know Dave Matthews.
I've heard him, but I just
you know what he
I tune
like.
It's fucking dentist music. I tune it out. guys who enjoy Dave Matthews wear no belts and suspenders over their collar shirts. Their little bow ties loosened.
Yes, exactly.
Fucking dump your duty on the highway at a campground.
Let's say hi to Mike in Alabama.
Mike.
Hey, boy.
Hey, man.
Did you know? Does this dummy know that? He can put a echo on that voice instead of having to sing the same lyric twice. They have a way to put an echo on the voice.
Oh, where he sings, we are the world, we are the world. But he likes jazzing up a little bit. You can't do that with an echo.
Yeah.
He puts a little inflection and affectation on the second part that an echo wouldn't do. So he's like, we are the world, we are the world.
Let's say hi.
It's like the fucking theme song to Alice. Ugh, that's what it is. It's that affected.
Was she affected when she sang
it? Oh, my God.
Fuck.
It's one of my favorite bits ever.
She was such
a little bit. A little bit. There's a new girl in town, and she's looking good. There's a fresh new face in the neighborhood. There's a new girl in town. Shut up!
No, you guys. Freckled face.
A fresh freckled face in the neighborhood.
Know what you gotta do? You gotta do Mustard doing the theme to Alice.
There's a new girl in town and she's looking good. A fresh new face in the neighborhood. Shut it!
Do we have Alice?
Oh, it's an oldie but goodie.
What? There's a new girl in town and she's looking good.
Just start it.
She's gotta sing the fucking theme to her own show.
Yeah, they're looking for it. Oh, you got it?
Yeah. Is that it?
I think so.
Used to be sad.
This is episode, season 5, so she might have really jazzed it up by now.
Yeah, because I think she redid it every season.
Yeah.
That's a hard
good fucking copy.
I find a better copy.
There she is at Mel's.
Funniest thing, the saddest part is I never knew why.
Oh, yeah, look at you.
Something myself for nothing. I think it's selling myself for.
There it is.
Yeah. She got so into this jazzy shit. And in between, I cooked and clean and made money giving head. Going through life with blinders on, it's tough to see. Oh.
I caught HIV. There's a new disease in town. God.
My favorite part.
Shut up!
Jesus, it.
Oh, let's say Linda Lavin.
That is a terrible fucking show.
Who agreed to let her sing the fucking opening to that? I remember seeing her on like Dinah Shore after she did the theme to that, and she put out a whole album of this jazz shite.
I want to see Vic Tayback putting those thick Greek diner fingers into her rectum.
Just fisting her asshole and go, blah, blah,
blah, blah, blah. He wouldn't get his whole fist in. He'd get like the five finger tips.
Because they're fat.
Yeah, big, thick Greek fucking coleslaw making fingers.
Vic Tayback.
Let's go to Teddy in Virginia. Teddy. Aww.
Teddy Olbermann?
Teddy Olbermann.
Hey, Teddy.
Is it me, or does, if you shave down Mustard, would he look like Macy Gray? Because he sounds like her.
Yeah, you got a little Macy Gray there.
Oh, Macy Gray. Yeah, you're right on that one.
Yeah.
All right. Are we losing, Jimmy, you going to attempt to make that flight to Cleveland?
Yeah, I have to.
Could you guys call us from the road?
Yeah, sure.
Let's make it a thing today.
All right, we'll let you know.
Because it's already snowing at Newark, so give us updates.
Is it really? Fuck.
So have Ken call from the car, and let's see how this goes.
A flight update just came in.
Okay.
Let's see what this is for
Jimmy's
Jimmy.
Attempting to get to Cleveland. He's playing the House of Blues. I hope everyone goes out of their way to see Jimmy because he doesn't have to do this. He could have canceled the show very easily, but instead he got an earlier flight. He's going to try to get his ass up there before the big snurricane hits our area.
Yeah, I think I'll be okay. I'll see you in a couple of days.
Couple of days?
I'm back for a while after this. Lucky devils.
We'll miss you.
Yeah.
Yes, Jimmy.
It's a word.
Bye, guys.
All right.
Bye, Sammy.
There goes Jimmy.
Jimmy Norton.
Why don't we take a break? Because now we're all sad that Jimmy's leaving.
Where's Kenny?
Yeah, I think he went to get the car or something, man. Huh? He went to get the car.
Where's that fucking...
We're sad, so why don't we take a break?
And, all right, well,
so
let's
we can hug
break.
Jim properly, and then we'll regroup and
do
the rest of the show.
By the way, if I'm killed flying, I really enjoyed being a part of the
Jimmy,
show.
Never say that. Never say things like that.
Yeah, please don't say that.
Look at him with his little bags and everything.
I'm running away.
You're adorable. Look at you.
Bye, GME.
You're running away. I'm joining the circus. Have fun. See Jimmy in Cleveland.
See you guys.
You're going to miss the Daniel Benoit birthday clip after the break, Jimmy.
Oh, great. We got it.
All right. He's going down the hall with his luggage. Quick break. We'll continue. O&A. I invented the talent show, Bobby. It's the Opie and Anthony show. Right here, and go. You still like Pearl Jam, right?
But yeah.
You like the Pearl Jam, don't you?
I've always liked the Pearl Jam. I think Eddie Vedder went through a phase where he was a real douche. But I think with maturity came the fact that, you know, he can't be such a, like, man kind of guy.
I didn't mind his man stage.
Really?
I didn't mind it. I wasn't jumping up and down, but it was all right.
It was just too.
Now he's back to
90s.
Just doing his thing.
90s was so about man.
It was the new version of man.
It's just passé now to be man.
But fuck, long lasting.
What fuck?
I said,
oh,
long lasting.
Yes,
this Pearl Jam. How many years have they been at it now? They hit early bands, 90s, right?
I love bands where it's like, how long have they been at it? It's like, no, they actually had their first album in 75. You're like, what the fuck? What?
Yeah, right.
Yes, Travis?
20 years next year.
20 years next year. The
Jesus.
Big 2-0 for Pearl
Are you
Jam.
Kidding me?
Wow.
That's unbelievable. I haven't been to a Pearl Jam show, ready for this, ever.
Really?
Yeah, that's one band I've always wanted to see. I don't know why I've never been to a show.
I see them.
You've seen the Pearl?
So I'm over at fucking Roseland.
Oh, that's right.
Fucking Pearl Jam, fucking Chili Peppers, and fucking, what was that tour? Yeah. And Smashing Pumpkins.
Smashing Pumpkins.
And Smashing Pumpkins was like the opening act. No one knew who the fuck they were, for the most part. And me, in my infinite musical wisdom, looked at these guys and said, who are these fucking losers? They're going to go nowhere.
You said that?
Oh, yeah. Because I was I was waiting for fucking, like, the Peppers to come out and shit and tear it up and fucking Pearl Jam. And it's like, who are these wannabe hippie assholes that are going nowhere?
Did you?
And it was Smashing Pumpkins.
Did you turn around and become a Smashing Pumpkins fan?
No, I've never really liked the Smashing Pumpkins.
Oh, my God.
Pumpkins.
I fucking like Smashing Pumpkins.
I don't like it. It's too meh. No, it's just, I just really don't like the sound.
What about, like, 1979?
None
of that stuff?
None
really?
Of that shit. It wasn't.
Fuck,
it didn't have a good fucking thump to it. No. I was like, you know what I was? I was like fucking, like Corrosion of Conformity to me was like kick ass.
Could you give me a little
90s.
Clean my wounds?
That was kick ass 90s fucking music. To me, this was like faggot shit.
Yeah, let's do some. Let's do Clean My Wounds,
COC
Travis.
COC is
fucking rock.
They were the shit for one song.
No, not one song. That whole album was great.
The album.
Didn't they have Albatross on that?
But this was 90s shit. Oh my God, I feel like we're sitting at AF.
Who gives a shit?
Oh, that's great.
You know what? Just play this fucking thing.
See, you can drive fast to this. Smashing Pumpkins is speed limit song. That's maybe under the speed limit. They were always put Jesus in their songs back in the 90s. Jesus was in a lot of songs. Yeah. Here it comes. Yeah, it's good. Filter is another band. I was like really into Filter. Butt Trumpet.
You're ugly.
Butt Trumpet.
All right, COC. Made this out.
Yeah.
God damn,
that's
is that
good shit. Isn't that good?
I know we're kind of dating ourselves, but fuck it.
No, I mean,
how about Helmet Unsung? Right on there, Kevin from Connecticut.
When you're talking about the 90s.
Well, now we're into a topic called Great 90s Songs, and Kevin from Connecticut came up with Helmet Unsung. Give me a little Helmet.
Helmut!
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 Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy, are we putting him through the paces. It's fun to watch him on this little TV now, too. Losing his fucking mind. Trying to find songs.
Soundgarden. Of course, Soundgarden. Of course.
Yeah. Good shit. Come on, right?
Fuck yeah.
Fucking rock.
It was a good time, man.
Damn!
It really was a good time, and a lot of this shit holds up. Your contribution
left a notice. Little Ozzy sound to his vocals, by the way. Right?
Oh, yeah, I hear that.
Little Ozzy sound.
What the fuck is this? We can do this bit, or you want to move on?
Yeah, we can move on. I mean,
if you got one,
make a little point.
Yeah. What about Rammstein?
Rammstein.
Can you give me a little Rammstein and then we'll stop this?
Rammstein.
Screaming Trees, man.
I wasn't really into the Rammstein at first.
And you know what?
They grew on me.
Blue Healer, I couldn't agree more. Fucking Tool.
Oh, yeah.
Fucking Tool. Look at this Rammstein. Oh, Jesus. This is just the best ever.
This is just goose-stepping music.
Turn this off.
Just fucking jackboots.
Yeah.
Get your fucking jackboots on.
Let's speed up an intern to this song.
Too harsh.
Too harsh now.
Yup, fucking Tool. You're right.
Too harsh. By the way, people are pointing out the obvious ones like Nirvana, STP, Stone Temple. Soundgarden. We're talking about those almost like one-hit wonders that were on the radio anyway.
But rocked.
But rocked.
Like the shit that
right
rocked.
Kill people of certain ethnicities. I don't even know what they're saying. But it's great.
A lot of drive fast music back then.
I gotta get to the actual fucking singing. It's coming up here.
Du hast mich gefragt. Du hast mich gefragt.
Right here. Oh.
This was just playing in Stuka Bombers while they were fucking blitzkrieging Poland. You know this is just blasting. Fucking bombs dropping. Nice panzers. Panzers just running over houses with families in it. Fantastic.
Right. Nice. Right.
Then they put a little 80s fucking Diddy Casio in
there. Yeah, I know.
Just to fucking do shit up a little bit.
Yeah, that fucked it up a little bit, right?
Euro trash.
I got the hiccups.
I make million-dollar deals on a daily basis. I can deal with this Euro trash.
What happened?
Hey, you do your work with guns. I do mine with a fountain pen.
I don't know that one.
Die Hard.
I gotta, you know what? Too much Die Hard action lately. I gotta see that movie again.
He is the ultimate douche in a movie, by the way. What was his name? Someone will say it.
You want to continue with this, Dan? Because there's a couple more good ones coming in. Remember Gravity Kills?
Yep.
What was the song by Gravity Kills?
Oh, God.
Travis, you gonna help me out with Gravity Kills? See that
scene? It's called Guilty.
Guilty, that's right.
I haven't heard this in a while.
Fucking Guilty.
Oh, what about Stabbing Westward?
Yeah, Stabbing Westward. That rock.
We interviewed all these fucking bands, every single one of them.
Yeah, Toadies, Possum Kingdom. Stabbing Westward. I still have Stabbing Westward on my fucking iPhone.
Yeah?
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
What song was it again?
That rock.
Wayward or something?
Oh.
No, what was this?
Put on that Stabbing Westward.
What, fucking Save Yourself?
Yes.
Oh, Save Yourself.
Save Yourself, yeah. Fucking kicks ass. I gotta hear a little of that.
I'm guilty. I'm guilty.
Yeah, we'll just talk about how ancient we are.
Yeah. I had a little filter action in there. Nine Inch Nails thing happened.
Listen to this shit.
Yeah, I remember this.
This fucking shit rocks. It's just loud. A lot of guitar. Fucking. I'm not emo. I can't fucking deal.
Yeah, but there's some good shit out there right now, man.
I know, Justin Bieber.
I love Justin Bieber. You should get into MGMT, I think.
This is fucking,
I think you would like MGMT if you go a little deep with that band, yeah.
I want to hear, I want to hear guitars.
Nah, but there's some good bands out there. The Killers are doing it. MGMT's doing it. Muse is a little, I don't know. I'm not sure if you were getting to Muse, but
this is great.
Yeah, absolutely.
And it just kicks in and fucking power rocks. And old Zombie, old Rob Zombie. Don't give me the new one.
Fuck the new one.
Yeah.
We go White Zombie, you go Rob Zombie.
What?
I go it all. Nah, we go White Zombie, you go Rob.
I do it all.
Thunderkiss 65, we're talking White Zombie.
It's a good song.
Sorry.
Power Man 5000. Remember Power Man 5000 too?
Yeah.
They didn't have many hits.
What about 7 Mary 3? Cumbersome.
Cumbersome. I have become cumbersome. And that's why I have become cumbersome in the world.
Yeah, here's Cumbersome. Hey, man, they're digging it because they're fucking requesting songs right now.
I know.
Yeah, but he rocks it up. He's gonna rock it up for you.
Toodly, toodly, toodly do, toodly do, toodly do.
I guess we are going off track a little bit.
A little.
Yeah, we wanted the ones that really rock.
Yeah.
Because that's the station we worked for, Sam. The only station that really rocks.
Yeah.
Even though four other stations in the market were playing the exact same songs. But we were the only one that made them rock.
Oh.
Fucking horseshit.
That's bullshit.
BCN played every single fucking song, but we were the only station that really rocks. How about Touch, Peel, and Stand? Yeah, that was a good one.
Yeah.
Space Hog, in the meantime, is one of my favorite songs from that era.
Yeah.
First World.
Yeah.
All right.
The old days.
All right.
The old days.
All right. And yes, we do have to mention our old friends, Godsmack.
Yeah.
This is a new Godsmack song that was on YouTube. I checked out. It was all right.
Good?
Yeah, Sully's still doing it, man.
In between playing those songs, we were also in, like, dirigibles and hot air balloons throwing bras full of water.
Oh.
Something's happened to my microphone.
I don't know what happened, Ed. That's so weird that it would crap out right at that moment.
My microphone.
Why are you doing that to us today?
I don't know.
Why would you do that?
It's part of history now.
Oh, hum. Hum. Give me hum.
Remember hum?
Give me fucking hum. That Stars song.
All right, that one, like...
I fucking love this
just
song,
just blast
too.
It. It starts out all mellow, and then it just...
I fucking love this goddamn song. You know, one of the guys down in Philly is a huge Hum fan. I didn't even know there was any other songs besides this one that anyone would get into.
Sponge.
Listen to this.
Yeah, it's all mellow. Man...
You're chewing lettuce.
It's okay. It's not kicking in yet.
Counting stars. We just want to kick in and then we'll move on to other things.
Say you miss the train of mine. They're counting stars. And live, that was so fucking loud.
Oh, yeah. They played one of our shows, didn't they?
Yeah.
They all played our shows back then. Back in the good old days.
Look at us reminiscing.
All right, let's move on. You can listen to that shit yourself, obviously. Are you putting all the stations that really rock on that big screen of ours there, Sam?
Yeah, I'm looking to find all the stations that really rock.
But shouldn't there only be one station that really rocks?
Yeah.
Why is there a whole list of stations that really rock? The only stations that really rock are AF, RXZ, OTT, UFO, LOC.
And that's just the first Google page.
And that's the first Google page.
Google.
Google. All right, Anthony, we had a birthday wish that went down in Syracuse.
Yeah, apparently. Well, you know how these things go.
Well, I mean, we're gaining listeners every day. That is a fact, by the way. Hearing from new listeners all the time, which is very, very strange to me.
Nude listeners?
New.
Oh.
They've missed so much.
I misheard.
They missed so much. You want to give them a little...
Well, you've seen in your local markets, in your cities, the news, right? And a lot of these news programs, they do birthday wishes, where some reporter or some goofy guy or the weatherman or whatever it is, they put up pictures of youngsters or maybe even old people and wish them a happy birthday. And tell, like, who in their friends and family, their circle of friends and family, are wishing them a happy birthday. It's cute, right? It's adorable. We've had the likes of Ted Sheckler. We've had
Paul Hargis.
Paul Hargis has been on there.
I finally got my happy 30th birthday announcement.
Was it just Gregory
Hughes or something?
Gregory. Yeah, and we've had a few of them. And apparently, there's a new one.
This is, I think, the third time that Channel 9 in Syracuse has been hit.
Oh,
really? Yeah,
oh,
what dummies.
Can they all they have to do is put the names in Google. Just Google the name.
Yeah.
That you're
Shut
doing.
Up. Why would you tell them what
you
to
know
do?
Why? Because they won't. They're stupid.
Okay, good.
They
good.
Won't.
Well, who got a birthday wish today?
Young
Danny Benoit.
Well, that's very nice. I'm sure Danny Benoit would appreciate a birthday announcement on this fucking wintry day.
Yeah, he'd be sitting there watching, because his family probably that sent it in probably went like, oh, why don't you watch this? And he's like, why am I watching the news? He's like, don't worry, just sit and watch.
Here's the problem. Danny Benoit, based on the picture they showed, is actually Daniel Benoit, the son of former pro wrestler Chris Benoit, who murdered his wife and child before committing suicide.
So this is one of the children that made it. So he's probably depressed today that he doesn't have a father and a mother and a sibling. So there he is at home and getting a little sunshine.
Daniel Benoit was choked to death by his father, Chris Benoit.
But that doesn't make sense. Then why would there be a birthday announcement for him, Sam?
I think it's a hoax.
A hoax.
A hoax?
I think it's a fugazi. It's a fugazi.
Fucking fugazi.
No, this is terrible.
Well, let's take a listen to this.
I-9. Yes. Okay, this is an I-9 moment.
Is everybody ready?
Yeah. Strap in.
Happy 10th birthday to Danny Benoit. He likes to play Xbox, lacrosse, and just talk on the phone. Happy birthday, Danny, from your wrestling chums, Vinny, Christopher, Eric, Sam, Greg, Tony, and Uncle Paul.
If you'd like to see your champion on our...
Oh my God.
He can't do any of those things, Sam, because he's dead.
He was also...
He likes to talk on the phone.
He was... Why talk on the phone? That's a weird one.
No, he was choked.
He was choked
with phone cord.
The phone cord. What?
Yep.
Yes.
That's it. By his father, professional wrestler Chris Benoit.
This could be the worst one I've ever heard. This is the worst one I've ever heard. Oh.
This Mars is fucking...
What happened?
Nothing.
Oh, no.
People forget who... whatever. Don't care.
Oh, no. After we were having such a good time talking about a poor dead child.
It's weird how people just forget who their friends really are.
Forget who you're fucking with.
Jesus. Well, I'll write it down for you.
All right.
We could play the Daniel Benoit clip again.
Yeah, we're gonna jot it down.
You got an idea, Ralph? You gotta jot that down. Let's see.
People just... It's weird how people just forget.
Oh, okay. There we go. Yeah, why not?
I just don't understand.
Oh, boy.
I don't understand.
I don't, why?
Huh?
Well, why?
Why what?
Like, why?
Oh, you mean I should understand?
You know what? Yeah, you should.
Really?
I'm at that point. I'm at that point. Yeah.
Well, we went out of our way to see the movie.
To see it. And we actually saw it, could comment on it.
We actually went out of our way to do the right thing, see the movie, so we could come in here and talk all about the movie.
Yeah.
And why is that never taken into consideration with our old friends?
I don't
know. What the fuck? You're saying I should understand.
Yeah, it's at the point now where I don't even, nothing surprises me. I didn't see certain people at the premiere.
No, why would he go to the premiere? He's too busy obsessing about everybody ripping him off.
I don't know. Oh, well.
He just announced yesterday that he invented the talent show. So, I mean, he's very busy, Anthony. He's very busy.
Wasn't there a show in black and white? Like Sid Caesar hosted it? I can tell you this much.
Howard said that he invented American Idol, and he's very serious about that, and he could prove it. I guess back in 1980, when he was in Detroit, he invented American Idol.
Yeah.
And then it just took about 25 years for other people to take that idea.
Thanks, Germ Freak. Arthur Godfrey had a talent show.
Right.
Because it is, in essence...
You can't go on a radio show and say that you invented the talent show.
Yeah.
Safe to say the talent show has been around since cavemen days.
Also invented, remember this too? Frunkus is reminding me. Also, he invented MTV Unplugged because people played acoustically on his show.
Mm.
So apparently that is also an invention.
Mm.
No one ever played acoustically on anybody's program
You never really saw Jim Croce on fucking, like, Mike Douglas.
No, no.
Yeah.
No, people always plugged in until Howard told people to stop plugging in.
Unplug that.
Yeah, the Gong Show. Thank you, Charlie Dog.
Hey, yeah, how about the Gong Show?
Thank you to Charlie Dog.
Well,
that's kind of a version, a goofy version of American Idol, but you get people to do their talent and then you fucking vote on it.
I don't know. You'll say anything when you're in negotiations, I guess. Whatever. Yeah. Have fun.
Have fun with
have
that.
Have fun. Godspeed. Good luck.
As you obsess about all that stuff, we'll entertain our audience.
Good luck to you.
But I guess Tracy Morgan is on his show right now, which, wow.
I didn't know Tracy was in the building. If I did, maybe we could have booked him.
Well, we were told that, you know, Tracy's not doing radio. Why would he do our show? You know, the show of the guys that went on their way to see the
actually
fucking
saw
movie.
The movie, could talk about it.
It's just fucking laughable. It's fucking laughable.
Oh, well. Maybe he doesn't like crunching lettuce in a microphone. I don't know.
Can we have that birthday wish again there, Sam? Someone is pointing out, too, that Hold On Loosely is being played during the birthday wish.
Is it? Maybe if Chris would have held on a little looser. See, it's a little, it's very subtle.
And there is a picture of the real Daniel Benoit, a person that the news spent weeks covering.
Yeah, yeah.
Weeks.
And unbelievable how they fall for these things. But they constantly will because they're puppets, they're newsreaders, they don't do their research. If it's put in front of them, they will read it, they will show it, whatever.
And that's it. All right, here it is again.
Happy 10th birthday to Danny Benoit. He likes to play Xbox, lacrosse, and just talk on the phone. Happy birthday, Danny, from your wrestling chums, Vinny, Christopher, Eric, Sam, Greg, Tony, and Uncle Paul.
And if you'd like to see your champion...
Uncle Paul.
Vinny and Christopher, of course, Vince McMahon and Chris Benoit.
Oh, Jesus. So this goes pretty deep with the references, Sam?
Vinny and Christopher.
Sam and E-Rock, Opie, Anthony, and Uncle Paul.
Uncle Paul, of course.
But Vinny's Uncle in there, too. And, of course,
Vinny and Christopher.
Of course, the name of the father who choked him out.
That more brutal.
For eternity.
More brutal than the Connor Peterson one.
Yeah.
That also made it to the air. Connor Peterson.
Another one that they spent weeks covering.
It was a huge national story. And Connor Peterson from your fishing buddies, I believe it was,
mm-hmm.
found in the ocean.
Let me say hi to Joe in Jersey. Joe?
Actually, they say that Elvis was really the first guy to really do the unplugged thing. That's where the MTV Unplugged really happened.
Yeah.
It was like Elvis just kind of hung around with his buddies and like 30 people would sit around and they would just do all of his songs acoustically. So, I invented the hip gyrator. Take care.
It's
Jersey Joe.
It's just laughable that he obsesses about all this stuff. It's complete lunacy is what it is. You can't go on a radio show and say that you invented American Idol.
You can if you got a microphone in front of you.
Well, I guess you're right.
You could say whatever.
Well, what the fuck did we invent then?
A little House on the Prairie.
We invented House on the Prairie?
I did. I thought about it.
Really?
I thought about the story of a young pioneer family that went out west and settled down near Walnut Grove.
Oh, that was yours?
It was all mine, and then they took it. Whew.
That sucks. All right, we should take a break, because we're fucking heating up.
I got to crunch some more lettuce, and I don't want to do it into a microphone.
No, we're heating up. We should take a little break.
Yeah, we'll simmer down a little bit.
I mean, we went out of our way. I mean, I even went and got a $20 haircut for the premiere. $20 fucking haircut.
Holy shit. Lemon Tree?
Didn't do Lemon Tree. It's a little joint in my neighborhood where they were advertising cheap haircuts.
I walked in
for a 1995 haircut.
Yeah, that is what we were told, by the way.
What?
I'm being told Tracy is not doing any radio. All right.
Yeah, it's just weird how this happens.
I know.
Because, you know, we were there for these people when they were kind of like not really happening anymore and... as they were rebuilding their careers. And then I was just talking to Anthony.
I know, yeah.
During the break on it. You know, we want the big hit. You know, we support these guys with some of their shittier projects. And I'm talking in general now.
Yes.
And then it's time for the big payoff where, you got the big hit. Congratulations.
It's a hit, right.
We've been friends and, you know, you've been on our show for years, and now we can all just kind of celebrate how cool this is. And that part never happens with us. It's so bizarre. Danny McBride, I love. He fucking has started blowing us off, and we had him in for a bunch of his things.
Yeah.
And now he's too big for us.
I'm really kind of thinking I don't mind being the show that's just shit on. Because it's so consistent.
Keeps us at the underdog level.
Yeah, and I kind of
like... We've been underdogs for 15 years.
It's annoying. I kind of like being the fucking battered wife. sit here, get punched, come
look
back.
Look that up. Have we set the record for being the underdogs the longest in the history of time? Anyone else out there been underdogs for this long?
I don't think so.
Steve, what do we know on this surprise booking that has been brought to our attention? Morgan is actually in the building and not doing our radio show.
Of course, nobody would go on record and say this. This is all sort of unofficial stuff. But I was told by Tracy's people that he was not doing any radio. He was going to do TV only. His schedule was booked. And this is going back weeks.
Yeah.
Weeks. Because this, obviously this movie's been on our radar for a long time. And
radar. I was invited to the set.
Right.
Jimmy's in it. We had Kevin Smith calling in between shots.
So the emails went out to the publicists months and months and months before this film was even done being filmed, and asking for the principal cast members, and they said, sure, we'll get back to you. And then, of course, the sorry, his schedule is slammed, or the no response. And then behind the scenes, what we were getting told is, don't be shocked if he shows up on the other show.
That's too bad.
Well, no big. Whatever. I'd rather just sit here and fucking talk about great fucking 90s music and yeah. Fucking Daniel listen to Benoit. Daniel Benoit fucking horror stories and
all right,
whatever.
We're gonna take a break and I don't know,
finish my salad.
Yeah, we're gonna finish. You're gonna do that. Oh, we got more We Are the World preview tracks. The song will be on the radio tomorrow. We're very excited about that.
And these are isolated tracks of the people singing without any music behind them.
Yeah,
so it really is abominable.
We'll do that after the break, but first, Black History Month. We're running out of days. Only a couple more days left.
Certainly are.
And we've been featuring some prominent black people.
Yes, we have.
Some prominent colored people.
Everybody goes over the same people every year. We find new people to pay tribute to.
And here's today's.
To celebrate Black History Month, the Opie and Anthony Show is paying tribute to those legendary African Americans without whom this country would not be the melting pot it is today. Today we honor actor Michael Jai White, whose role opposite Martin Sheen in the 1997 comic book adaptation Spawn made him a household name. Well, not really.
Are there any normal people left on Earth? Or is everyone just back from hell?
It did, however, open the door for bit parts in Universal Soldier: The Return, The Dark Knight, and, shit. Stay tuned for more icons of black history on The Opie and Anthony Show.
Opie and Anthony. Can't let it go, can you?
I can't let it go.
Newark Airport, a lot of snow out there. I wonder if Jimmy's going to make his flight to Cleveland.
Holy shit, look at the snow at Newark. Let me check, because I got one of the best apps ever. I love my goddamn iPhone. Flight Track. You ever see Flight Track?
I've heard of Flight Track.
Flight Track rocks. I can punch up Jimmy's flight. It says scheduled. It's still scheduled. We'll see what happens. 9:45. Supposed to take off, they'll cancel that motherfucker.
Well, let's get a fucking I want an update from Kenny.
They're still there. Let's see what the FAA is saying about delays and closures.
Okay.
At Newark Liberty International. Traffic has experienced gate hold and taxi delays lasting 15 minutes or less. Something tells me this isn't quite updated. I bet it's going to be longer.
All right,
we'll
Kenny.
We'll see. Poor Jimmy.
How you guys doing? Doing. Little BBM to Club Soda Kenny.
Oh.
All right, Anthony. Fuck that shit we were talking about before the break.
Fuck that shit.
What are you going to do?
It's just raining at my house.
We just expect more from our show, from the people that work with the show, and it just never fails to amaze me that it's not much of a big deal to anybody except us.
I thought we were taking a break to get off of that.
We are. I was just summarizing for the people out
there.
I
understand.
It's very, very frustrating is what it is.
Now, we saw the movie Cop Out.
I thought we were moving on.
Oh, I'm just saying, we saw the movie Cop Out.
Oh, come on in.
Come
on in. The door's open, brother. The door's open. Come on in.
I am wickedly surprised.
At what?
At the reviews.
Why?
Because they're not that flattering. Well, saw this movie.
Well, what the fuck did we see then?
Here's what I saw. I saw a movie that on purpose was kind of playing off of the old cop buddy movie thing. Not making a cop buddy movie and trying to bring the genre back, but like kind of doing it as like, hey, remember these?
Yeah.
Remember these movies?
We're going to have fun with this.
We're going to have fun with
genre,
that genre
you know and love.
Days Gone By, right. The whole, Lethal Weapon, 48 Hours, Die Hard thing, where, you know, because there's a scene in this movie where Tracy Morgan and Bruce Willis, playing the buddy cops, go into the lieutenant or captain's office and get yelled at. And get told to, you know, turn in their badge and gun. Who is going to watch that and think, oh, this again? Without knowing that that's exactly what they plan to do. It's like, you wouldn't do that and think this is a new idea. But the reviews I'm reading is kind of like they're taking it like he's made this like it's a new thing.
Well, maybe they should have went all in. And basically said, we are going to mock buddy films.
You know what it is, though?
Maybe they didn't go all in, so that confused the reviewers. Like, are they making fun or are they making
fun? But that's, I think, what made it good was that it didn't go the route of, like, Scary Movie.
Oh, right.
Where they make a goof movie about those types of movies. Like, this, it fit it, the genre. It holds up as one of those movies from the old days like that. But it's updated and does goof on it and have those
but we talk about how stupid the people are out there.
Of
course not the people that listen to our show.
No,
highly intelligent,
completely retarded.
So maybe they needed to be, like, as we say a lot, spoon fed. You know what I mean? Instead of keeping
reviewers need to be spoon fed.
Why? How bad could the reviews be?
Rotten Tomatoes is cheerashing it. Rex Reed is still alive. Are you kidding me?
I think his son does some reviewing now.
Is that Rex Reed?
Yes. Rex Reed himself?
I would have sworn he had the hip.
Well, I don't even...
No?
He's got a son, I think, that does movies.
What?
Yeah.
How does that happen with anal?
I don't know.
How do you
get
a son?
We don't know what Rex Reed's about.
Oh, you don't?
I don't. I really don't.
Interesting. Well, Rex Reed panned it, I guess, huh?
Yeah.
Well, then it's done for. A lot of people gave it, like, the reviews, which were in the line of just goofing on it. Like, let me read a couple.
But Rotten Tomatoes, what are they? They take all the reviews from across America, give it one solid percentage. And what percentage are they up to for this movie?
Well, it's 13% positive, so that's 87% negative.
Oh, Jesus.
That's not the movie I saw.
Smith's directorial style is far too slack for this material, which aims to be an homage to populist 80s classics like 48 Hours and Lethal Weapon, but only winds up resembling one of the bargain bin knockoffs that floundered in those films' wake.
That was Variety magazine.
Oof.
Yeah.
That was Variety?
That was Variety.
What? But
Variety's not a big publication or anything, right?
It's gigantic.
Fairly
large.
Oh, really?
Wow. Industry publication.
It's been huge since, like, I think fucking there's pictures of, like, Clark Gable reading it.
Yes.
How
many,
ah!
But how many people in Hollywood take them seriously? Come on, Sam.
Probably
most to
and
all.
And it Gone with the Wind, too. Yeah. Let me look at the review in Variety.
Oh. Yeah.
Let's see. This is some soul-sapping da-da with which director Kevin Smith is staining his already dubious resume.
Says Time Out New York.
No, that's a small publication. That one I know is a small one.
That's little.
No one reads that.
All right. Cop Out is a clumsy postmodern buddy cop flick that stuffs as many genre references as it can into the ceaseless patter between Tracy Morgan and Bruce Willis.
That's the Associated Press.
Oh, AP.
Which means it kind of goes everywhere.
Not really. AP's been replaced by Twitter, I think.
I mean, as far as newspapers
yeah,
go,
I don't think AP's okay. A big one.
I didn't realize
anymore.
Scroll a little.
This
bit.
Is the year 2010, there, Sam. This isn't like 1992.
Get a new batch.
Who listens to AP? Come on.
Let's see. I'm trying to see. Okay. Smith's staging, composition, editing, and humor mark him as utterly incompetent.
That's the New York Press. Next to it is Entertainment Weekly's review.
Oh, Entertainment Weekly.
Is that a publication?
Entertainment Weekly is rather large. It's got a large number of readers.
Yeah.
All right.
Name one reader.
Yeah, who reads Entertainment Weekly?
Name one reader.
Guess Sam Roberts.
Right.
Maybe one.
Well, but who are you?
Right, that's true.
Okay.
Let's see what Entertainment Weekly is saying. There's not a whole lot to cop out besides watching Kevin Smith pretend with a crudeness that is simply boring that he is an action director making a comic thriller about cops versus a Mexican drug gang. Parentheses, yawn. Wow.
Maybe, is Jay Moore awake? He does a good Tracy Morgan.
We can just talk to him about
the
movie.
Yeah, why not?
Oh, yeah. We'll just talk to him about it. I don't understand. Like, they're bashing it based on what they shouldn't be bashing it about.
Well, can we get a real publication out of these?
Well, I mean, Entertainment Weekly and Variety.
Give me one that's real, though, Sam.
How about Marshall Fine from Hollywood and Fine?
I know Marshall Fine.
He's a Hollywood and Fine.
Yeah, but he's a friend of Brother Weeze. I find his because he knows movies. This guy, Marshall Fine, really knows movies. What is he saying?
This alleged action comedy is flatter than a tortilla in a panini press. Come on, Kevin Smith.
Isn't that come on?
It says come on. You know, it's a C apostrophe M-O-N.
And how do you pronounce that?
Come on.
But isn't that just come on?
Come on, Kevin Smith.
You really need a
come on,
you
Kevin
really need a
Smith.
Fucking vowel in there?
Quit smoking weed and write a new movie of your own. Come on.
He's blaming the marijuana smoke.
I figured that one out. And that's from Hollywood and Fine. Get it?
The marijuana intervention's coming soon. I know that.
Village Voice. Well, they gave it full studio budget.
I guess.
First time in his decade and a half career, Smith is still making movies about guys just like him.
It's kind of neutral.
There you go. That's from the homosexual paper, The Village Voice.
The Hollywood Reporter is the last one.
Which The Village Voice is usually used to roll up so you could stick a gerbil in it.
Oh, wow.
That's usually what The Village Voice is.
Well, the gerbil needs running room.
He does.
He's going to get in that asshole.
Up to speed.
Right.
Really got to get up to speed.
Yeah. Sure.
You can't just dangle him there and think he's going to drop in like a fucking crater.
Just think pole vaulting without the running before the
pole
vaulting.
Yeah, you ain't going over that fucking thing.
Fucking
He needs some running track. He needs some giddy-app room
right.
in that Village Voice
to pop through the,
rolled up.
To pop through the puckered section of your asshole.
Yeah, that pucker will stop a fucking gerbil in a second.
Unless you got a lot of speed.
The Village Voice rolled up to open up the cloaca and the sphincter.
What is a cloaca?
I know muscles sphincter. In there.
The
cloaca. I always laughed at that word.
Let's say hi to Logan in Austin. Logan?
What's going on, boys?
What's up, Logan?
Hey, man.
Does it seem like this criticism might be a little bit harsh, kind of like they're trying to get back at him for the Joel Siegel shit that went down a couple years ago.
Ah, you know something? He did get into some arguments with some reviewers. So,
You know what? But why? This is a perfect. This really is a perfect reason why Kevin Smith needs to be on this show.
I know.
To fucking speak his mind about the reviews and take on these people. Let's take them on.
Yeah. Yeah, get here.
I thought I saw a good movie, but maybe the excitement of knowing Bruce Willis is three rows behind you and Kelly Ripa is right behind you. I know that Kelly Ripa...
Steve Guttenberg?
I know Kelly Ripa actually had to move her head to see around my head. That's pretty impressive.
Just saying Kelly Ripa and head in the same sentence is exciting. Right? Exactly.
So...
Hmm.
Yeah, maybe. But, I mean, Kevin Smith has never shied away from this type of thing, so I...
No, he hasn't.
I know a lot of people are trying to get his attention on Twitter, and he's pretty much ignoring all of you for some reason.
I
don't know. Let's do this. Let's do this!
Come on! I don't get it, because the movie I saw, I thought was very... Jesus. I thought it was very funny.
You liked...
I left going like, wow. And believe me, I had my doubts going into it.
Yeah.
Because of some of the trailer and stuff kind of made it look like maybe they were trying to make one of these movies instead of make a homage kind of parody of.
I see that. I want to say hi to Eddie in St. Louis. I had a choice there, and I went with Eddie.
How you doing, guys?
What's up, Eddie? Eddie's our pal in St. Louis that fucking loves hockey way more than I do.
Guys, I am just so fucking proud of Team USA, undefeated so far. But I tell you, yesterday that game between Canada and Russia, I would have never called that. They blew that motherfucker up.
Yeah, it was 8-2, the finals. So Canada moves on, and Russia goes home to their communism.
Yeah, the Final Four is...
Well, hold on a minute.
Year is this?
But you gotta think they're still commie bastards, aren't they?
Yeah, they pretty much are.
All right, so why are you laughing at me? They're as red as they used to be. They're still a shade of red.
Yeah, they definitely are.
All right.
Yeah.
It was pretty impressive. I mean, Canada's gonna be tough to beat. I can't sit here in front. I want to see USA versus Canada for the gold medal, but that game scares the hell out of me. But what the hell? I'm not walking away with a medal. I just want to see a great game, so that's why I want Canada versus USA.
Yeah, well, I mean, all we have to do is knock off Finland, which doesn't seem like it's going to be a tall order. But I just have bad luck as a hockey fan. I mean, with my luck, we're going to get Finland against Slovakia in the gold medal game.
Who the fuck would watch that? Except
nobody.
Finns exactly and Slovakians.
Slovakia. I know.
Who would see that game?
USA against Canada would be huge.
That would be just a monster game.
Big, right?
Put it this way.
I would watch it.
You would, right?
I would definitely watch that.
Well, I think the USA there should have scored a few goals, but that Hiller guy was standing on his head.
They're ready to bring it. That's all I know. Bring it.
We just had some bad luck.
Bad luck?
We had some bad luck, but we're going to need to turn that shit on, because I think we got the edge going into a game against Canada, because obviously we did beat them, but if anybody's going to make adjustments, you know they will, and they're going to be ready. So it's going to be a bloodbath. It's going to be a hell of a game, but I don't think anything's going to stop the U.S. from playing Canada.
Your hockey commentary is flatter than a tortilla and a panini press, my friend.
Honestly, that whole Kevin Smith thing you guys are talking about, he's never going to have respect from mainstream critics.
You're absolutely right.
But I don't see why you'd even give a fuck. I mean, you know, a guy like Kubrick never had an Oscar for best director.
Eddie, come on!
We give a fuck because Kevin...
Thank you, Mike.
Smith, we consider a friend, and he should be in here to take on all this. He's never shied away from this. Let's go. Let's do this. Let's do this whole
thing.
He'll
probably drop in. I wouldn't doubt if he
You're still holding out hope that we see him walking down that long hallway in the trench coat?
I think so.
I hope so. Because Tracy Morgan has officially blown us off, so... I guess he doesn't remember when we were trying to help him sell tickets to Caroline's and stuff before he reinvented himself. I guess he forgets those days. Eddie. And the other game, what do you think? Canada's going to have an easy time with Slovakia?
You don't want to get caught sleeping on any type of Olympic team in any sport, but
sleeping?
Yeah, who the fuck sleeps during a sporting event?
Oh, my God, someone was sleeping during the game?
That's impossible.
Wow.
Yeah,
even if you want to fall asleep, the ice is a hard surface.
And there's
it's
like
be very
noise.
Uncomfortable.
And someone's going to wake you up.
Yeah.
I don't even know how you'd fall asleep.
Right.
Come on.
Come on.
Come on. I'm not even using it. I'm using an apostrophe.
The only thing is the way they set the brackets up. You know, like if you look at the NHL playoffs last year, you had the Penguins and the Flyers, and that was, you know, I mean, they have great matchups, but you want to save something like that with all that animosity for a finals game.
So yeah.
I think Russia and Canada might have played each other a little too early.
Oh, really?
That's all I got for you guys.
Well, that's all I had. What about the women's game today? You got Canada versus USA.
Yeah, what do you think about these bitches?
Yeah, I'm definitely going to watch it because I want to support Team USA, but I don't know who's going to win. I can't really handicap the thing because I don't give a fuck.
I don't know, man. I've been enjoying the women's hockey. And by the way, someone was wrong because my Vancouver fucking connection said that there is hitting in women's hockey.
You have a Vancouver connection?
Hey, calls the show.
Wow.
You don't remember the guy that called the show?
I don't remember anything.
Amada or something? He was like a dirty Muslim, but he knows something about Olympics?
See, when you say the things to me, Opie, like, how the fuck do you remember the theme song to the Doral commercial from 1972?
Yeah.
I sit in amazement that you can remember someone that called NEW fucking 8 years ago.
Yeah,
and be like, hey, I remember this guy. No, he called about this, that, the other. I'm like, if he called me personally yesterday, I wouldn't remember him.
So you got to care about people, and then you would understand.
True. All right. Valid point.
Yeah, we have very different
valid
takes on
point.
Things. All right, Eddie, I think that's good. What else?
That's pretty much it. I think the USA is going to skate away.
Taste me. I'm come on and taste me. Baseball. Take a puff and let me do my stuff. Taste me. Sorry, I was just singing the Doral song from
really
1972. Yeah.
Wow. That's fucked up. That's pretty impressive, though.
Which it was hot to hear the girl singing Taste Me, Taste Me.
Oh, yeah, because you know what that means.
Yeah.
You're
big hairy bush that smells
that
like cigarettes.
Bush.
Great.
That's right.
That's what you want.
Get right in there, right, Ann?
Tasty, tasty. It had that unlocked little filter that looked like a chamber.
The pussy?
Yeah. The Doral filter.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh,
well, you never know. It was behind that hair. It could have been.
Oh.
I like how you used to have to pry it apart like you're going through a rainforest.
Need a goddamn machete.
What's in there? What? No. That's a labia majora. I'm a little... I got to go a little left. Wait a minute. Nope. I didn't quite hit... Ah, pay dirt.
That hair made things a little confusing.
That's it.
You are
finally,
so right.
Finally found the old filet mignon. It did make things difficult.
I agree. Fuck.
A lot more challenging for us, you kids out there. We really had a hunt for it.
That's right. You enjoy your bald pussies.
Yeah. Know exactly where it is.
We fucking paved the way for you bastards.
Oh, my God. You know, these days, it's great because it's like, look, no hands.
Right.
You could shove that in with no fucking hands these days. Back in the day, you were grabbing the bottom, just punk, punk. Where is it? Where the fuck is it in this mess? I can't tell. Shonk, shonk. Shoving away with your hand wrapped around the base. Now you slide up, it goes whoop right in.
We heard a lot of whoa.
Yeah, whoa.
Hey, whoa.
Well,
what do we know?
Fucking take a weed whacker to that fucking thing.
Fucking there was hair from the belly button all the way through the asshole.
Help me out here, Henry.
Right. Whoa.
Yeah.
Well, fuck, man. You know, it's not defined. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Now it's a fucking, like, GPS. That fucking, like, the dip. The dip guides you right in.
Right in there.
The dip was fucking crowded with shrubbery back then. You slid right off the runway.
Eddie, you still here for our pussy talk?
Yes, sir.
All right. Yeah, well, I, you know what? I there's nothing to say. We're all just keeping our fingers crossed for the game that I think a lot of people want to check out. And that would be on Sunday. They play tomorrow, right?
Yeah.
All right, Eddie.
Thanks.
Thank you, sir. There goes Eddie. Let's say hi to Ian Halperin. Ian?
Uh-oh.
Yes, gentlemen. Who better to talk about than hockey than Ian, His Highness Halperin, the man who played against Mario Lemieux when he grew up, the man from Canada. And I'll tell you one thing. Right now, Slovakia might be going all the way. They have a goaltender who plays for the Montreal Canadiens named Halak in goal. He's the newest. He's like Vladislav Tretiak. He looks like Dominik Hasek. You guys, I'm telling you right now, U.S. is going down to Finland.
And I'm going to be very happy because Finland has the hottest women in the tournament in the stands.
Just stop.
And what do you mean?
USA.
What do you know about sports that I don't?
Listen, I just know USA knows how to bring it.
Yeah, we already beat you at your own fucking game,
yes.
Ian.
And
stop being such a pussy. Don't you want... Why would you want the easy game for the gold? Why wouldn't you want fucking US of
USA.
A?
USA.
To show the world that it was a fluke the first time around. What's wrong with you?
Who is going to make you guys look like fools. Saku Koivu played for the Montreal Canadiens. He's the leader of Finland. He has heart and soul, unlike the USA.
Unlike the USA?
I'm telling you right now, Finland is going to destroy them, and Slovakia, watch out.
Yeah.
Slovakia.
Yeah, I played against Lemieux. Google that one. Mario Lemieux I grew up. He once beat us 13-1. He scored all 13 goals against us.
So you didn't do very well, did you?
Well, His Highness scored the one goal for our team.
Oh, you
but,
did.
You know, if I wouldn't be doing your radio show, I might be playing in that tournament today.
Oh, right, exactly.
Anthony, breaking news.
Yes, breaking news. Hold on there, Ian. Yes?
Howard Stern just announced that he invented the bald pussy, so we can't take much credit for that one either.
Yeesh. Well, thank God, then.
Yeah, we praise him for that. Inventing that. Thank you. Hairy pussy's like trying to take the prize out of a full box of cereal.
And God damn, is that good.
And no credit because the guy fucking Facebooked that from his phone. Put a little name on these things so you get a little credit. Ian, fuck you. Fuck your fucking country and fuck,
come on,
and
you
fuck Canadian hockey.
You know, I wrote a poem for Anthony.
All right, let's hear it.
You want to hear it?
Sure.
What's your obsession with Anthony, by the way? It's getting a little weird.
I mean, Anthony's dynamite. I love the guy.
All right, it's a little weird.
I wrote a poem for him.
All right.
It's Anthony, his love for His Highness like honey. No Cleopatra, ugly as a mud fence, toilet sounds like a foghorn. His love for His Highness like a money, so pungent, his jealousy like an onion. Face and feet ugly as Cruella de Vil. His personality and head bald as a bandicoot. Loose ass needs to do some squats and lunges. I still love Anthony. His love for His Highness like honey. Insecure, defensive, Viagra vibe. Shaken baby syndrome way back when. Balls look like butternut squash soup. Shakespeare sonnets. No Cleopatra. Rattled by the rush. Anthony. His love for His Highness like honey. How's that, guys?
That sounds like you wrote that for someone else.
Yeah,
because it really doesn't fit me. All of the things you were saying.
Come on, it fits me like a glove, dude.
How do you? What do you think
I
need?
If you were in that courtroom, you couldn't have worn it.
You know what? Hold on.
You think I need Viagra?
Well, it seems like you've been in a rut, dude.
Rut?
There's so much testosterone coming out of your nostrils, even. You know, it seems like you need a weekend in Canada, dude, just to be shaken up. You ain't getting it in the U.S.
What the hell is wrong with you? That was so fucking gay. You completely sounded like you want my fucking cock. That poem is all about. Oh, I'm supposed to... Is that your fantasy that I'm worshipping you? Is that your fucking fantasy, you Canuck cunt, that I worship, that I fucking worship you? You know what I'll do? Just to show you I don't need Viagra, I'll bukkake your big stupid dice sunglasses, you fuck.
Jealous
of what? Jealous of what? Someone that comes from a second-rate fucking country that we defend so you can fucking sit there and have your premier, prime minister, president, whatever it is, come here for health care? You live in a shithole. You're full of crap. Why don't you go try to make another dime off of Jackson's rotting body, you lying sack of cock? Go ahead. Go ahead. Go to the Michael Jackson ATM. Try to pull some money out of his rotting fucking asshole. Go ahead. You're fucking full of shit.
Because I know everything. Google it.
Shut up. Play the saxophone with your bunghole, you homo.
I'll play the saxophone.
Go fuck yourself.
With one hand, dude.
Go fuck your mother.
When are we going to hear this saxophone of yours?
Exactly.
We've been hearing that for a month.
Yeah. No, when I'm back.
You're all talk.
Yeah. I'm bringing a chick to give Anthony a lap dance because he needs it badly. Man, the guy's frustrated.
Frustrated?
You know, he's a jealous
You know something? You're absolutely talking about yourself.
I know
dude,
that.
You probably you have. Number one? I'm number one.
You probably have quite a lot of trouble attracting the attention of females. I have to say, you probably have quite a bit of trouble.
Right now,
your rap
I'm the hottest
sucks.
Looking guy in radio, and you're just jealous.
Your rap really sucks. I'm sure any woman that would sit across from you would know in 3 seconds you're full of shit, full of yourself. All you're doing is talking. The pomposity that pours out of your gullet is such crap. Is such crap. Come on.
You ain't getting it, dude. You're jealous because His Highness is getting it.
His Highness?
Who's His Highness?
Are you trying to give yourself a fucking name?
Anyone called you sexy?
Are you trying to... What?
When was the last time anyone called you sexy?
I've been called that. Believe me, I don't have to fucking prove.
Time?
I don't. You think I gotta prove myself to you,
absolutely,
to the likes of fucking you?
Absolutely.
When was the last time you were called anything but a lying sack of shit, asshole, pompous, self-centered cunt? Riddle me that, asswipe. Riddle me that. When was the last time someone called you Dice, by the way? How many times a day are you called Dice? Hey, Dice, where you been,
Dice? Don't insult Dice.
You fucking look like a homo Dice. You look like Dice right after, if Dice sucked cock, it would be Ian Halperin. That's what you look like. Go fucking open Michael Jackson's casket and see if a dime is in his pocket. You fucking grave robber. Go ahead, grave robber. Snap off his fucking rotting nose and sell it. Write a story about it. Write an exclusive about his fucking nose that you snap off. Shut it. Shut up.
You're jealous, dude.
You lie about everything. Oh, yeah. Brad Pitt and Angelina Jolie are still together. They're still together. Well, if they break up in 10 years, you'll be still. I told you. Google it. I said it 10 years ago. Shut up. You fucking, there's not, you got nothing.
Look,
you have nothing. Nothing.
Tiger Woods.
And we're going to see.
What was his Tiger Woods promise?
I don't. What was your Tiger Woods promise, Ian?
Promise.
That hasn't come true.
When he tells a statement, he's going to fucking bring out one of his whores and say he's leaving with her.
What is it? What's your latest line of shit?
Yeah, you know something, Anthony?
Yes, sir.
I haven't seen you win many awards for your journalistic endeavors.
What award do you have? What fucking award do you have? I have an AIR award. I have a fucking AIR award for excellence in broadcasting. I have awards that I have won for my production skills.
Radio and Records.
Radio and Records was a big one. How about I have broadcasting awards that were given to me by Charles Kuralt, motherfucker.
Oh, yeah, Charles Kuralt. Big deal, dude.
Big fucking deal. What award do you have? The fucking Canadian bullshit award? Is that the one you have? The Canuck can't fucking tell the truth if his balls were in a vice award?
Dude, I haven't seen you write many number one bestsellers.
Yeah, and what have you written?
Yeah, well, you know, my Michael Jackson book.
Oh, again, yeah. Go off of that one. Go off of that one.
Dude, have you read my book?
My Michael Jackson book. You're like Kevin Meaney with
the only guy covering Jackson the last 2 years. Everyone
no one talked about Michael Jackson and the pedophilia and the fucking how he looked and what he was doing. And no one talked about it. Wow, you're a fucking pioneer. You're a regular pioneer, Ian. Holy shit.
Accused of child molestation. You're just jealous, dude. You're jealous.
Yeah, that's what I am.
You once wanted to. You envisioned yourself doing a moonwalk on stage.
Yeah, Tiger Woods sex tape. Yeah, what about the Tiger Woods sex tape? Where is that?
All that you're getting is a bunch of.
You heard the Tiger Woods sex tape. What happened to that? Where's the audio? Come on.
It's gonna merge. I never gave you a timeline. I said.
All right. Of course, you never gave me a timeline.
Tiger, what I'm saying is...
Maybe things only come out after people are dead. We got to wait until Tiger Woods dies, so then you could capitalize on it. You fucking grave robber. Go dig someone up and pull their gold teeth out, you grave robber motherfucker. Shut it.
Don't call me a motherfucker, dude.
You are.
In that studio, dude.
You are.
I will bring chicks.
chicks.
Yeah, right, like your saxophone. Yeah, imaginary chicks like your saxophone and that you played with Mario Lemieux. Shut up. More lies. Holy
shit. That one? Google it, dude.
I have never... I'll Google it.
Yeah, Google that one.
I'll Google lying piece of shit from Canada and watch your face come up.
Dude,
that's what I'll do.
Every Canadian listening to this show takes offense because they know my brand. And I'll tell you one thing.
Your brand?
I put these guys up in Canada, but they're not impressed with all this.
Oh, no.
When was the last time you were in Canada, dude?
I don't even remember. Why would I care?
And that's why you're so fucking frustrated, because you can't get laid.
And Canada is the only country to get laid in?
Canada has the hottest women, dude.
Are you?
The first night you go out with them, you know, it's a happy ending. It's
oh, is it? Yeah? Where do you get your roofies? Where do you get your roofies?
How much does that cost?
That's the only fucking way you're getting laid, is if she's sitting there vomiting on the edge of a bed.
I think we had a good night. Could you please not report me?
She's always born with love.
Oh, is that it?
Ian,
jealousy.
But it doesn't always die.
Ian, I have to agree with you. I think.
What?
I think you've really hit on something.
What? Jesus.
And silence is virtue.
After Googling Ian and Mario, it just says you're both from Montreal. Wow. Wow. You are just fucking blood
Mario
brothers.
Mario Lemieux from Villamart. He played for the Villamart Hurricanes.
Oh, good. Wow. How about that?
13-1.
Isn't that something?
And I was the only guy to score a goal against this team.
Oh, were you?
You know, let's go skating. When I come to New York, let's go to Rockefeller. What do you call that?
Yeah, that's good. We'll hold hands in your fantasy. In your fucking fantasy, we'll hold hands and have a romantic comedy moment, you fucking sap.
Don't forget about the hot cocoa.
Get out of here. Yeah. What are we going to do?
Jill Nicolini in the middle of us both.
Oh, there you go. Here he goes. It's the only thing he could ever try to bring up. That was well over like a year and a half ago.
You know, let's get Nicolini on the phone and find out. You know,
is that all you can fucking talk about?
Well,
is that the last? Is that the last time you were ever even near a fucking woman,
dude?
Was that it? Is that your fond fucking memory of a woman?
Dude.
How about something new? When was the last time you were even laid?
Last night.
Oh, last night. Yeah, cute. I bet.
What was his name?
I bet. Yeah, exactly.
Name?
I bet. What was her name? Quick, what was her name?
I don't kiss and tell.
It's not a kiss and tell. It's what was her fucking name?
Dude,
could have said anything. Karen, fucking Gloria, anything. It's not a kiss and tell.
Guy.
It was, you know what? You couldn't come up with a fucking name because there was no girl.
Dude,
there was no girl.
Never waste jealousy on a real
your name. Your girl is the fucking same hand you write that trash with. That was your girl last night. You put down your fucking pen and picked up your little fucking excuse for a dick and jerked it off.
Jealousy's nothing more than a fear of abandonment, dude.
A fear of abandonment? I have friends. I have family. You know, things that you know nothing about. Sincerity. You're just full of shit, Ian.
Hey, man, you'd love to be as full of shit as me, dude. And you know, that's all.
Wow, good one. Ooh, you got me.
And you wouldn't be so
models
frustrated.
You never got near that fucking shampoo model, by the way. Fucking got near her.
I got to bring her on the line next.
Oh week. Yeah, bring her on the line.
So
yeah.
When does the
restraining order expire so you could fucking stalk her?
You would have liked to go out with that Pantene woman.
Enough with the next time.
You jacked off after I told you. You were fantasizing.
Here he goes again. Boy, do you love me? Are you in love with me?
Yeah,
are you
yeah.
in fucking love with me?
Yeah, I love you, dude.
That's all you do is talk about
hot.
Me and my sexual fucking exploits.
You're not hot. You're not my type, but I'm definitely in love with you, dude. We're gonna get to know each other really well.
Ugh. Ian, you disgust me in every way.
Oh, man. The jealousy would be far less torturous, babe.
Is
if
that
you wouldn't
it?
Have this, you know, undying passion for me.
Yeah.
He's saying that you love him, man.
You know, that's
oh, is that it?
Yeah, that's what he's saying.
You know how many times I think about Ian?
It means he's after his highness, man.
Here's,
oh, yeah,
here's
his highness. I forgot.
Here's the
it's
only
Ian,
times I'm even thinking about Ian Halperin.
Okay.
Sometimes when he's on the fucking phone on this show, because a lot of times I'm just twittering and texting girls and my friends and my family. You know, things you know nothing of.
Man, hey. Good for
wow,
you.
Wow, you're so quick. You're so quick-witted.
Holy shit.
You're not getting laid, man. You're taking it out on me.
You're taking it out on me.
And why are you taking it out on him? Why are you taking it out on the highness?
I don't know. Maybe we got off on the wrong foot.
Google me and Jill Nicolini.
Yeah?
Google it.
There's probably going to be a picture of me and Jill. Because anytime you Google me or Jill, that's what comes up.
Did she lick your crack?
Go to
Did she?
Go to images.
And he asked you a question.
What?
I don't kiss and tell.
There's not one picture of you and Jill Nicolini.
When you put both names?
Not one fucking...
I don't kiss and tell, but get Nicolini on the phone.
No, there's not one picture on Google Images. Now put in Anthony Cumia.
Yeah, because, dude...
Yeah, because what?
He banged her.
Because what?
He banged my leftovers, but, you know, he'll promote it to the world.
Yeah, see, first picture that comes up. First picture that comes up. Because I could back my statements up.
Let's
not like you.
Nicolini on the
I don't know
phone.
What a docking
Let's
picture is doing up there.
Let's see. I want to know from Nicolini who's more well hung, His Highness or Anthony.
See, because again, you want to fantasize about my cock now? You are a disgusting fucking closeted mo. You're a mo.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
You really think so, right?
Yeah, I really do. With your flamboyant fucking notice me glasses. Get the fuck out of here,
jealous,
you attention
dude.
Whore.
Dude,
you're an attention whore.
Because right now, you know that I got the sexiest voice in radio right now. You know I'm a threat. And that's why.
A threat?
I'm not going to drive me crazy when
a
you know.
A threat
you know,
to
I
what?
Walking distance over there.
A threat to what? Holy shit.
You know, you're taking my leftovers, dude.
Leftover, there's nothing that proves anything. I'd watch myself. You're probably gunning for a lawsuit. You're gunning for a lawsuit for bullshitting about that from Jill, because there's no proof whatsoever to what you're saying.
Oh, yeah, well, I have witnesses because it was a threesome with Jill.
Really?
Did you ever do a threesome with Jill?
Who was the guy?
No, it was actually a nice
what was
thing.
It? You, nuts laying on your
it
face while he did the real
thing.
Work, while he
dude,
did the real job. What did you
threes.
Fucking? Did you
I
suck?
Threes.
Did you booyah his balls? Did you booyah his balls in your mouth? Is that what you did? You booyahed his balls while he did all the work.
Jeez,
thinking you were thinking it was a threesome. It was a twosome with a obnoxious interruption.
Yeah.
Did he come on your glasses?
Oh,
come on my glasses. Come on my glasses. Bukkake. Giggly.
You know, even your listeners.
Oh, God.
Your listeners,
shut up. I'm looking at beautiful tits. I'm looking at beautiful tits right now from a girl that's showing me her beautiful breasts on Pal Talk. Enough out of you. My God.
Hey, man, he's called the Highness. What are you called, Anthony?
The Highness.
That's his name.
Ian Halpern and his Highness.
Oh, shut up, His Highness.
Have you seen my movie, His Highness Hollywood? Maybe you should see it, dude.
All these
really? Beautiful chicks foaming over me. Just salivating
oh,
over
it?
Me.
Did you edit out the part where you fucking dole out the dollars to them afterwards?
Yeah, of course.
It's the only way you're getting fucking chicks.
Yeah, I don't pay to play.
How much money do you spend
you
on fucking prostitutes?
Your own experience, man.
How much money
That's
do you spend to get
to
laid?
You up to Canada so
sitting
you can
there.
Finally get laid without paying.
That lonely fucking ass just sitting there going, yeah, send one over. Yeah, let me see. Make sure she's hot.
Dude, that's what you probably do every night. That's
oh, wow, another good one.
Is going.
Another
yeah,
good
you're
one.
You're making millions
wow.
doing the show probably, but you're probably broke because you've supported, you know, the Ashley Dupre's of the world.
Ian's movie, His Highness, by the way, Amazon.com sales rank 128.
Hey,
1,598. It's ranked 128,598 in movie and TV. You
go
ass cunt.
Trailer, dude. Go to my trailer.
I don't even
it's
think there's been that many
YouTube.
Movies made.
Go to your
in
trailer.
History of movie
I don't know
making.
Where you live. You fuck.
Is there
what films have you done recently, brother?
Oh, that's gonna hurt it.
I'm not in
That's
the film industry, asshole. I know my limitations.
Because
you don't seem to. You don't seem
industry.
To.
That's why you're fucking in radio, and that's why His Highness is on the fucking big screen.
Oh, yeah, because I'm sure, you know, you're just gorgeous. I'm sure girls just look at you and fucking, you know, oh, my God, what a guy.
Could we at least
Anthony,
look?
Anthony is lovely.
You're the guy that said,
like honey, no Cleopatra.
You're the guy that said, fucking, Brad Pitt isn't attractive.
dude, because maybe you'd you're the only motherfucker still fantasizing about Pitt.
No, I'm not fantasizing about him, but I'm a realist in the fact that girls do seem to like the guy, and not you. Huh?
Angie Jolie seems to be the only...
Angie Jolie. Right, could you not fucking use... Act. Could you not use names like you know these people? Angie Jolie. Angie Jolie. Could you not make it sound like you know these fucking people?
How do you know I don't know Angie Jolie?
You were probably one of these that used to say Chuck Heston.
Yeah, Angie Jolie.
Shut up.
Come on, Chuck Heston.
You're a sack.
Fantasizing about him?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing, fantasizing.
You know, Moses is... You know, you should read the Ten Commandments, brother.
Should I?
Absolutely.
Should I?
I think, and I'm speaking on behalf of everybody, everyone part of the tribe listening to this show.
The tribe.
That Anthony should convert.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
As you go over to Judaism?
You are going
to... If you're a representative of Jews, if you're a representative of Jews, I don't even want to say what is on my mind. If you are a representative of Jewish people, don't make me even say it.
Dude,
because I think everyone knows what I would say. Everyone knows what I would say.
10 more years of bad luck. I'm Cohen.
88!
You know what a Cohen is? The Jews.
14 words!
And right now, you should bow down your motherfucking ass to the King of the Jews, His Highness Halperin.
You're King of the Jews?
You're insulting me.
It was Jesus.
When you insult me, you're insulting every motherfucking Jew out there.
Oh, fuck.
And then I'm going to have to phone my good friend
Charles Small,
the head of the anti-Semitism.
Oh, shut up. Where's Pontius Pilate when we need him?
And I don't want to put
crucify you too. Shut up.
But you're spewing anti-Semitic sentiment.
Yeah, that's what I'm doing.
Do you hate all the Jews?
No, I said if you're a representative of Jews, then don't make me say it, is what I'm saying.
Do you know what a motherfucking Cohen is?
What?
Do you know what a Cohen is? Google a Cohen, dude.
Enlighten me. Enlighten me with
I'm a king. When I go to synagogue, people actually, when they find out I'm a Cohen, they bow down to me.
Shut the fuck up.
What does that mean?
Shut up.
There's very few of us left. We're the kings. There's different people in the Jewish religion. There's Cohen. Yeah. There's Levi's.
Levi's.
I got Levi's. Cohen, dude. Yeah,
you're Levi's. What does douche mean in Hebrew? What is douche?
Yeah, douche.
Because that's all I'm getting out of you.
Man. And one thing I'll tell you, jealousy will just, everyone's jealous.
Yeah, there is a little jealousy coming from you.
A little bit.
Yeah, Opie, is that what you're saying?
A little bit, yeah.
Jealousy?
You're talking to the king of Jews.
Yeah, I know, a Cohen, right.
Please, Cohen.
Okay, Cohen.
I like the Cohen brothers. Is that the same thing?
Hey, the Cohen brothers are good, man. I respect that.
What's the synopsis on his movie that's 128,598 on Amazon? Have there been that many movies made in the history of filmmaking?
No, I'm sure not.
No?
He's off the fucking chart. You're out of bounds.
Hey, dude.
Your fucking book is out of bounds, or your movie is out of bounds as far as even being rated.
What movie's just above him that is selling better?
His Highness Hollywood.
Wait, we're going to read the synopsis of your movie. Shut up for a second.
See the reviews of my film.
Could you read that, Sam?
Yeah. I wonder who reviewed it.
Sam's going to read the synopsis of your big movie.
A new film from Supa Dupa Productions.
Supa Dupa?
Yeah.
That's just like Warner Brothers.
Yeah, exactly.
His Highness Hollywood is a rollicking, irreverent, and controversial look behind the scenes of Hollywood. Posing undercover as a gay actor who
was... What posing were you doing?
Did that come easy to you, Ian?
Yeah. What a stretch. Wow. Gay.
A gay actor who is a member of the so-called Israeli royal family. Filmmaker Ian Halperin...
Who is that? I know we have Ian Halperin, but who's filmmaker Ian Halperin?
Ian Halperin infiltrates the world of headshots, auditions, fame, and ruin... But in true Hollywood form, something unexpected happens.
Oh, really? He actually makes a point?
He infiltrates the Church of Scientology, who promise him a cure for his alleged homosexuality.
Alleged. I'm glad they put in alleged.
And in the process of exposing the secrets of the world's most coveted trade, he meets up with numerous A-listers, including Brad Pitt, Jay Leno, Leonardo DiCaprio, Bill Paxton, Ron Jeremy, and Sigourney Weaver, who are most eager to give him the inside track on what life is really like in Tinseltown.
Oh, wow.
Again, it's ranked 128,598.
And with that said, somebody's looking at the rest of the list. Howard the Duck outranked Ian's movie by about 100,000.
Yeah. So when you were undercover, how many cocks did you actually take undercover?
Look, I'll tell you one.
Hey, no, it's not gay if it's undercover. It's not gay.
Google it.
Shoot my ass. Shoot my ass. Go ahead. It's not gay. I'm undercover.
What?
There's two cocks that have left an imprint in Hollywood over the years. Errol Flynn. And His Highness.
And we're talking to His
Highness. Yeah. What did you dock with him?
This is a very
I'm getting a star on the Walk of Fame there.
Yeah, this is a very special
day. Oh, my God.
This is a special day.
You're going to be there, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll be there.
Oh, yeah. You'll be there, dude.
Are you getting a star on the Walk of Fame? The day you get a star on the Walk of Fame, I can't even think of something so horrible to even bring up that I would do or say or anything. You are never. Why would you ever get one? What have you contributed
actually in the film. If you watch the film, you'll see me in the Hollywood Chamber of Commerce, and they're doing my application.
Annoying them.
And let me tell you.
Oh, something. An application. That's good.
Will tell us right now.
Meanwhile, you need a shitload of people.
On the Walk of Fame first.
You need a shitload. You need a shitload of people to actually vote you in to get a star. They have to back you.
25,000 cash. And let me tell you, I will get my...
Oh, 25,000 cash? You better sell a few more of those piece of shit ranked 129,000 movies.
You're going to pay for it because you're the biggest skeptic. But when they say, all I need is the cash, I'm going to come to you for the loan.
Oh, is that it? Yeah, good luck with that.
Because you got to put your money somewhere besides demented... misinformed hookers.
I'll tell you what, Ian, that's a good idea. I'll lend you the money. Come to my house at night. I'll leave the door open, and you just walk in. The lights might be off, but don't worry. You'll see a flash, and then you won't see anything. Just walk right in.
I'll be there, dude.
Okay, no problem.
I'll be there with Jill Nicolina.
Oh, here he goes. He's can't
obsessed
leave it alone.
With Jill.
He is so
I think
obsessed.
There's a jealousy there. I don't think
she's
he ever
so
got
fucking,
Jill.
You know what happened? Yeah.
Yeah.
She's so fucking just like didn't even acknowledge he existed. Right. He finds out I was with her for like the entire summer, and you are completely jealous of that fact.
Why don't you let him smell your balls?
Let's get Nicolini on the phone, dude.
You want to smell Anthony's balls?
Get Nicolini on the phone.
Get her on the phone.
Get her on the phone.
Loves me. I don't know if her mother loves you, dude.
Get her on the phone.
I don't give a shit if her mother loved me.
Dude, you're a skank.
Care.
She brought you home. Her mother fucking flipped out. You almost put her into cardiac arrest. She almost had
Really? Yeah. Day. Yeah, you were there. Is this another exclusive piece of bullshit that you're going to write down somewhere?
Dude.
Stop.
You know it's true.
Oh, really?
Admit it. She thought you were a skank.
Admit it.
Come on.
A skank?
Fess up, Anthony. She wasn't too thrilled when you walked through the door.
Guys are dirtbags. Girls are skanks. What are you fucking talking about?
You're a skank.
No, I'm a dirtbag.
You're a skank.
You're a skank. Now I'm throwing his insults back at him. Nya, 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 nya.
You'll get your callers on the line. Who would they rather sleep with, His Highness or Anthony?
Oh, Christ. All our callers are men. All our callers are men.
Yeah, man. We're
so
in our
I think,
show.
I guess you win.
All right, we'll put some guys on. Mark in Canada.
I
Mark.
I from chicks.
Mark.
Not guys. Guys will want to sleep with Anthony.
Oh, is that it?
Mark.
I would like this idiot to shut up because every time he talks, their fucking dollar is dropping. He's a fucking retard.
This is a Canadian, by the way.
I'm from Canada. I've never even heard of this piece of shit.
Fuck it, Ian.
If he is a representative of the Jews, please put him in the burner.
Yeah, Ian, if you're,
yeah, there you go. There
if
you go,
you're a
dude.
Big Canadian, why weren't you at the opening ceremonies for the Olympics? Maybe, you know.
I could have sang that anthem. You want to hear me sing the anthem? That woman who sang it, Nikki Yanofsky, it was a big disaster.
Yeah.
And I'll tell you one thing. There was a guy who used to sing the anthem. His name was the late, great Roger Doucette. Him and Kate Smith were the only two people who ever got the anthems properly at sporting events.
The gayness that is coming out of your fucking maw right now.
Let's hear his version,
Kate
though, Anthony.
Smith.
Let's hear your version, Ian.
Yeah, go ahead.
It's so early in the morning. I'll give it to you here. I'll give you a few bars, okay?
Here we go.
I'm like borrowed.
Oh, Canada. How's that?
Keep going.
Oh, wow. What about the high part?
Yeah, you didn't get to the high part.
Well, you can tell by the way I do my walk.
How's that?
He's fucking. You're out of your mind. Now he's singing Bee Gees.
Fucking 5 in the morning here.
You're out of your fucking mind. Finish the anthem, man. Let's go.
Oh, dude, it's too early for me. But
it definitely is. That's what the listeners are saying.
Let's say hi to
early for you.
When I come into your studio with Jill Nicolini sitting on your face.
Let's say hi to Nick in Canada. Nick.
Hey, I've been a promoter for about 15 years in London, Ontario, which is only about 6 hours from Montreal, and I have never heard of this guy.
There's another one that's never heard of you.
Hey, dude, I'm not. This ain't a popularity contest.
Oh, really?
Who they'd rather sleep with.
You're the king. What's the matter? I thought you were the fucking king.
I'm not running for real.
I thought you were the Cohen. What happened? No one knows you.
Dude,
no one knows you. No one knows your work.
Yeah, we got.
No one
cares.
All right,
listen, we got Ian Halpern on the other line. Ian Halpern? Ian?
Yeah.
We didn't know how to do the bit. Jesus Christ, Kent. Stop listening to your fucking radio.
I know. What an ass.
Let's go to Chris in Ontario. Chris, you're on with Ian Halpern. His Royal Highness or his Heine? What do you call yourself?
His Heine ass.
Chris, go ahead.
Shut up, Ian. I just want to let you guys know this guy does not fucking represent us. Please don't think that he's anything like the rest
Canadians
of us.
Canadians hate you.
Yeah, they hate you.
They hate you. Americans hate you more.
Look, you know, all the greats are hated at the beginning, and then they all come around. Look at Howard Stern. Everyone hated him at the beginning.
Oh,
the guy's making, what, $110 million a year?
Let's say hi to Birdman.
I don't mind.
Again with this jerk-off. Again.
I know.
I got a call. Every time I got a call, this jerk-off has got to be on the phone.
You're talking to Birdman, Ian.
Hey, Birdman.
Ian.
Birdman, listen up. Who would you rather sleep with, me or Anthony? Tell me right now.
Why are you propositioning men to sleep with? Take me out of this.
We might have to erase the alleged out of your synopsis for your movie.
I'm cutting to the chase, and you guys are going to listen to me.
I got an Amazon ratings update. I got an Amazon ratings update.
All right.
As we know, His Hollywood Highness, Ian Halpern's movie, is ranked 128,598 on Amazon.
Right?
Yeah. You know it's rated at 87,700, which is just like twice as good as your piece of shit. Anus McGillicuddy. There's a movie called Anus McGillicuddy, which is ranked 87,000. You're at 129,000.
Well, at least I'm ranked. I'm just moving on up.
Moving on up.
He's got you there, Ed. He is ranked.
He's ranked.
We don't have a movie that's ranked.
You're certainly,
You're right.
Boy, Anus McGillicuddy.
At least Opie's.
Who someone's got to pick that name up, by the way. Yeah, new name.
Because, you know, one thing, I'll say there's no doubt. You know, I'm a much better looking guy than Anthony, but Opie, I always.
All right, not that.
See, again, it's this fucking homoerotic fucking talk. It's always about, like, your sexual prowess and what guy is hot.
All your fucking listeners seem to be men. Where's the women? I haven't heard one woman call since I've been on this show. You guys.
Exactly. Exactly. Do you understand that? Since you've called, not one woman calls. You made your own fucking point, Anus McGillicuddy.
Before I was on, there was no chicks beating down your door to get on the show. Where are the women?
Well, they're out there.
They disappear. You're woman repellent, you fuck.
Having me on because I'm going to just build your audience with chicks.
That's what's going to happen.
Oh, okay, wait a minute. This guy has got some, he's going to explain Cohen. Seth in Virginia.
Seth, turn off your fucking radio thingy and talk.
We got a lot of new listeners, and they just don't understand how this fucking thing works.
Sorry about that.
Seth, go ahead.
My office.
Let her rip.
I just wanted to let him know that Cohen is the last name. Cohen is what you claim to be. Number two, Cohen's were the high priest. Not the king of the Jews. There is no king of the Jews.
There's no Cohen.
I would
Cohen's.
Rather hear intern David talk about Judaism.
Are you trying to give me a lesson about...
No, Ian, there's no Cohen's. It's Cohen's.
Are you trying to give me a lesson about where
I am
from, how
no
I
No Jew
up.
Will ever bow to another Jew.
There you go.
So
see?
You are in the
God's eye traveling, dude.
Not only are you misrepresenting Canada, you're misrepresenting the Jews.
He misrepresents everything.
Yes, let's say...
You guys are all against the Jews. There's no doubt.
Let's say hi to Matt in Queensbury. Matt, you're on with Ian Halpern.
Ian, I got to side with you. I think you're right that the listeners would probably rather sleep with you because judging by your face, you really know how to work the balls.
You know how to work the balls, Ian?
I'll take that one. Yeah. I'll take it one.
Right. You like that one?
Yeah. You got to give it to him.
Yeah, well.
Holy mother of Christ.
All right, why don't you guys make up?
No, I love Anthony. I love him, but, you know, by the time we're done here, he's going to be up in Canada getting laid for real.
Is that my goal
with Anthony.
Is that my goal?
Yeah, you know, the poem I gave him, it was from the heart. And I want somebody to put that on YouTube so everyone could Google that one.
Oh, yeah, yeah, I'm sure.
That poem wasn't written for Anthony.
That poem was...
I don't even know what it was.
It was a lump of shit.
Could you take us out?
Battlefield Earth rated 10,000. From Justin to Kelly, 25,000.
Jesus, and these
were... Anus McGillicuddy, 87.7. I just love saying that.
And finally,
of course, his Hollywood Highness, 128,598 things are better than his Hollywood Highness.
Dude, you know, as long as I'm playing, as long as I'm ranked. Some of the best tennis players are ranked 3-400. You know,
3-400 is different than 128,000.
Read the reviews, dude.
Who are they written by?
Good point.
Yeah.
Look, all my reviews have an initial after them. I H.
He likes
horse.
Why don't you sing us out with the Canadian national anthem?
I'll give you the old Russian answer. Why can't he ever do what we want? I was in Russia before the fucking Kurt Wall fell. And
oh, really?
It was one of the best trips I ever had. Here you go.
They let a Jew just walk around Soviet Russia?
I went there trying to get Sharansky out of there, but I ended up having a motherfucking good time over there. I got a bit sidetracked. Thank God he finally got out. Here you go.
I was with Jill Nikolinsky over there.
The old Russian anthem, I'll give you a few bars of that. Союз нерочинный, а ёмнишка поти. How's that?
That's very Russian.
Yeah.
But just when it's about to kick in, you bail on us.
Well, it's early in the morning. Let me tell you, in honor of Anthony, I'm going to go out with a hot Russian.
Ian, you're fucking...
Wait, we got more info coming in.
Your movie has one review.
Oh, yeah?
It only has one review.
Why don't you post another one for me, dude?
Zero of three people found it helpful. One review. Written by you, I'm certain if it's positive,
no, I don't write
it's written
own,
by you.
One thing I don't do is write. I never write my own reviews. You Google yourself all day, man. I'm busy.
Yeah, that's what I do.
I'm busy getting laid while you're fucking on the computer Googling yourself.
Yeah, of course you are. That's why your asshole hurts so bad. Stop it.
Yeah, let's.
When are you coming out of the closet, dude? Just be honest. Be honest. All this homoerotic talk, all the fake, I've been with this one, that one, the fucking shampoo model. You know something? The shampoo model pushed it a little too far. Because that chick was too hot to even fucking give you a tenth glance.
Oh, yeah? Maybe I got to bring her on your show when I come to the studio.
Yeah, why don't you do that?
I will.
Bring her on the show.
I will. But you got to be a gentleman, dude.
A gentleman? You know what? You could watch me fuck her. While you sit there wondering what it's like to actually please a woman.
Condoms, all with the letters O and A on it, she's still not even touching you. Dude.
Oh, really? Is that right?
Yeah.
But you're just a prize, aren't you, Ian?
Well,
you're a prize with your notice me fucking glasses.
Dude, I'm giving you a challenge.
I mean, Halperin, look at me, notice me, notice
right
me.
Now. You bring in your broad, I'll bring in mine, and I'll video it right on YouTube and see who could go longer. And see which chick comes out with a bigger smile at the end of the session.
Great, great.
Let's see you put your money where your mouth is.
Good idea. Like you do in front of glory holes. Right. Exactly. So what you're saying is, what you're really saying here is you want to watch me fuck a girl. You are a fruit. You're a fucking Canadian fruit. What kind of fruit do they have up there in Canada? I want to call you a Canadian fruit.
Canadian fruit, right?
Halperin's.
Yeah, the Halperin. you're fucking...
See, here he goes. I have every motherfucking Jew listening to this right now.
Not one review on Rotten Tomatoes.
You're going to be all over the internet on these anti-Semitic alert sites.
Oh, is that it? I'm already on them, dummy.
Let's say hi to Cookie. Cookie!
Have you ever banged a Jewish chick, Anthony?
Hi, Cookie.
Hi, I'm Cookie. and I'm from Canada. I'm Jewish, and I'd rather sleep with Anthony. He's much better.
Great, thank you, Cookie.
Ian. Let's go to Kate in Cali. That would be California. Kate.
Hey, boys. I just wanted to let you know that women listen to this program every morning, and he couldn't be more gay.
Yeah. See?
Google it.
Hey,
let me
tell
you something. You have a nice voice, and I'd like to meet you sometime and prove to you whether or not I'm gay.
Wow, you got some rap.
Wow.
I'd like to prove to you I'm not gay. That's a great rap. I'm going to use that one when I'm out one night. Hey, baby, I'm going to prove to you I'm not gay. Yeah,
the whole world thinks I'm gay.
That'll work.
I'm going to prove to you that I'm not gay.
How many drinks have been thrown in your face?
Let me go to
loads thrown on your back.
Let me go to another Kate. Kate in Massachusetts. Kate?
Hi, guys. How are you?
Hi
Kate. We love Kate.
She has a beautiful voice. Hey, Kate,
how
you doing? Look, let me ask you a question, Kate.
Here it goes.
Yes.
Who has a sexier voice, me or Anthony?
Anthony.
Really? You really think
Thank you, Kate.
Would you bang Anthony?
If I had to choose between you and him, hell yeah, him.
Would you let him come on your face?
See, look at these fans. Kate, you don't have to play party to his fucking whimsy.
I know one-on-one. And I think we should bring Kate to studio. If she sees us both in the studio, I'm betting everything I have, including my saxophone, that she'd go for me.
Let me tell you something.
This is your fucking mistake, dude. It has nothing to really do about how you look.
I was just going to say that to Ian. Like, Ian, do you understand a woman's, like, mindset?
Because
let me tell you something.
How's about agreeing to this? Anthony takes you out on a date, and then His Highness takes you out on a date.
And then see what happens.
And
course.
Report who
of
you'd
course.
Rather date.
All right. More importantly, we got Larry King on the line. Larry!
Good morning, boys.
Hi, Larry King.
Good morning. Ian, question.
Larry, first of all, Larry.
Covering up your homosexuality. Go.
Larry. What a mess.
How much Viagra have you taken this morning?
Yeah, was worth interrupting.
It's always like about Viagra and hard-ons
Let me go to Ahmad Ali. Now, Ahmad Ali is working the Winter Olympics in Vancouver.
Oh, okay.
Salam, Ahmad.
Ahmad.
How's it going?
Hey, Ahmad.
Salam. Hey, Ian, why don't you talk about your perjury charges back when you were a student reporter in Montreal?
Oh, shit!
Let me
look at what he dug up on Ian.
Oopsie!
No, let me tell you something about that. A lot of people have brought that up. I won the Rolling Stone College Award for Investigative Journalism over that. Some guy tried to charge me for perjury, and let me clarify that. Last time I heard it, never even before went in front of a judge. I won every motherfucking award. The guy was fired because of my articles. So let's talk more about it, dude. What the more fuck have you got to say? I could charge you for anything, brother.
Ooh.
But the fact is, you got to prove it in the court of law. It never even
defensive.
Went in front of a fucking judge.
He's so defensive.
Ahmad?
Let's talk about it.
Yeah, Ahmad?
I don't know the details. I mean, Ian's much, much, much older than me, so that goes beyond.
So
that goes
let's
way
talk
back
about it, Ahmad.
But what about your
accusation? When was the last time you won an award for something you were charged for and you were acquitted of? It never even went before a judge.
You should never have to say I was acquitted of that.
Right.
Like, even that isn't good, Ian, by the way. If you said, never convicted, I was never convicted. Like, that's never good.
This guy was fired. He tried everything on me. And I won.
Yeah, he won. Ian won.
All right.
Google it.
Google it.
Somewhat, Ahmad. 30 years
what
ago.
What about the Montreal Expos who had an issue with you back in 1984?
No, I had an issue with them. I actually sued the Expos for $100,000.
For what?
What? For saying something false about me in the press, and it was
that you were straight.
Ian alleged that there was racism in the clubhouse.
There is what?
I didn't allege that. Several players did. And then
I remember the story.
It was a big deal in Canada.
What was it?
You know, you just come up with some nuggets and you don't finish the sentence properly.
Well, explain yourself. I mean, the Expos came out and said that you were basically lying, right? In a freelance piece you wrote for the...
No, they said the player was lying, and they said that I had a history of accusing athletes of racism, and I never did. That was the first article I did about racism in sports. And I sued them. They didn't sue me. I sued them.
No, they actually came out in public, though, in reaction to your article, and said that it was just a racial goad, that it was basically a red herring.
No, that's not true. They said somebody else, a third party, goaded the player, not me, into saying those remarks. His name was Bob White. You could phone Bob White. And I was just doing my job reporting, but when they came out with that,
you know, I went after them. They never came after me, the Expos. Never.
No, but you've been writing about racism.
Dude, look, when you're in the kitchen in the fire, you know, everyone denies it after. That's why I tape everything, I video everything, and I make them look like fools at the end of the day. You know, nobody's ever questioned how I do my craft.
Ian has been writing exclusively about accusing white people of being racist against blacks.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, since you were in college, right?
That's his Canadian white guilt that he has that, for some reason, I don't know why,
Well, you're saying there's no racism, sir, in baseball?
Why would I say there's no racism? Of course there is.
You don't think people should cover racism?
There's racism in every aspect of life, sir, yes. So what are you breaking open? What great fucking revelation are you exposing? That there's racism in this country or in Canada? Wow, you're amazing. When's your next book, The Sky is Blue?
Oh, you're gonna love my next book, dude. It's coming out soon.
Oh, what's it called?
I'm not gonna tell you.
Oh, well, okay.
Well, why? Wouldn't you want to promote it so it's not 128,000
Let's see where
on
that's
Amazon?
Ranked.
Hey, let's say hi to John Coltrane. Oh. John.
Hey, Coltrane. Train.
What's up?
Ian, I would like you to sing one of my favorite songs right now.
My favorite things?
Yes. Can you hum the melody? Where is your saxophone?
Yeah, here. I love my favorite things, actually. Train, you know, he took Charlie Parker to the next level.
You know, get on with the song, fucker. Let's go.
Dude, I'm not going to sing.
Where's your saxophone?
Dude,
you said you'd be in the studio for the last three fucking weeks. Where's your goddamn saxophone? We want to hear it.
Hey, you want to hear me with my favorite things?
Sing the fucking, hum the fucking melody.
Dude, I will gladly come in. Here you go.
You'll gladly.
You know,
I'm a fucking melody already.
Imitation is the biggest form of flattery, but let me tell you something. Let me get the train on here.
All right.
Let me get train, but the real deal.
Where's your saxophone? Is it in California or in New Zealand?
Yeah, that's the great train.
Yeah, but you're not doing the song.
Well, you know, one thing I won't do, I won't try to step into John Coltrane's shoes. Yeah, this guy's playing his cock, man.
That's Zamfir, master of the pan flute, you fuck.
Yeah, what do you got? That's what we got.
Yeah.
It's got that. What do you got?
I play the real deal.
You haven't played shit.
I don't try to step in.
The mouth organ?
Yeah.
That's what you play, you fruit.
I'm not going to try to imitate John Train.
Why don't you play something then?
Dude, I sang for you twice.
I just blew you away on the fucking slide flute.
Yeah, what do you got? What do you got? What do you got?
Jacking
what do you got? What do you got?
What do they got?
Yeah.
Chlamydia.
Ant just played something. You play something. I don't care if you pick up a goddamn spoon. You better play something.
Dude, I'm going to come in your studio. I'm going to play. I'll bring Nicolini in. You're going to see who she
is. Yeah, there you go. Again. Oh, my God. You one-trick pony fucker. You really are
but
a one-trick pony.
Man.
Well, who doesn't?
Anthony and I are going to get to know each other.
Who doesn't?
Well.
It better be soon before your fucking HIV kicks in, you fruit.
Anthony's going to be at the premiere of my next movie introducing it.
Oh,
really? Oh, yeah. You're going to be invited, dude.
Where's that going to be? Do you have to pull down the screen yourself in your basement?
And you're going to be
and turn on a projector? Is that where your movie premiere is?
It's on 8mm. Here's me as a child in the pool.
I want to sit and watch your slideshows.
Let's get more women on the phone. I'm tired of hearing
it. You're a repellent for women. A repellent.
Foghorn voice. Let's get some chicks.
We want to hear the saxophone. Enough already. Let's hear something.
I'm on assignment right now.
Assignment.
I can't travel with my horn.
Would you stop trying to sound important?
I'm not trying to sound important. But
you are a nobody.
All right, you want a woman. Let's go to Mindy in Arizona, where it's not snowing.
Oh. We had a huge snowstorm this year. I am so glad that Anthony is finally ripping this guy apart. He is such an ass, and has been ever since he's been on. Half the time, I turn him off because I just can't deal with it.
Haven't you had it with him?
I am so done with him.
You're hearing my voice, not your partner's.
You know, you're putting my face to your partner. I know that.
Okay, no, one, your voice is
horrible.
Have
you ever fantasized about His Highness?
No, your voice is horrible.
So let me ask you a question.
Attitude sucks.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you do for a living?
It's none of your business, but
I want to know. Well, you're on the radio, dude. Let me hear what you do in life.
I'm a senior financial analyst.
Oh, yeah? For which firm?
I'm not going to tell you that.
Why not? There's no client confidentiality here. Like,
I'm not going to tell you where I work.
This is his rap, by the way. This is his fucking rap.
Well, apparently the only woman he's ever fantasized about is Jill Michelini, because that's all he talks about.
That's all he talks about.
You have fantasized about her, too, haven't you?
What?
No.
Do you like Jill?
I'm rubber, you're glue.
Let me ask you a question. If there's one celeb you could sleep with, who would it be? Male or female?
Male.
And who would it be?
It'd be probably Brian Dennehy.
Yeah, I like
Jesus,
Dennehy.
Jesus, Brian Dennehy.
I like big barrel
Even we could
guys.
Say Jesus.
Wow.
What the fuck?
I like
fuck?
Big barrel tested guys.
Brian and if there's one chick you could sleep
too bad Steve's
with,
gay.
Brian Dennehy just went, what?
Why yeah, would you sleep with a woman? You've never had a lesbian experience?
Joke, Steve.
No.
Joke. Jesus.
No.
You've never fantasized about a woman?
No.
When was the last time you got laid?
Would you? Why are you
Again,
going into this
none
line
of, your
of questioning?
I called to say what an ass you are. It has nothing
yeah.
to do
yeah,
with it. It's important. It's important.
Like, this is how you operate.
The heart
this
of
is
the subject.
This is your fucking, the way you operate with chicks and girls and
no
women.
Wonder he doesn't
that,
get laid.
Yeah, exactly. I could not imagine a girl really feeling this is nice. Yeah. Like, this is a nice conversation that you're having.
It's horrific.
Isn't it just terrible?
There goes Mindy. Thank you, Mindy.
I have the sexiest voice in radio. Everyone knows that.
All right. You know something? If you even did have the sexiest voice, the words that voice is making are turning girls off quickly.
Why don't we go to Dee Dee? Dee Dee.
Terrible.
I'm starving
you. Don't have a good rap. You're horrible with these girls.
Let's say hi to Dee Dee, though. She's a woman. Dee Dee?
Yeah, you want fuck? You want fuck?
Anthony?
Yes, sir.
Anthony, I would sleep with you anytime. This guy is so gay. Why is this Canadian boy on the radio?
Exactly my sentiment.
Where are you from, honey?
I'm from New York.
Oh, yeah? Let me ask you.
I'm commuting.
You really
to
sleep
work.
With this guy, Anthony, tonight?
No, and you are a bore.
Would you shag this guy tonight?
Shag.
Like, really?
Anthony, I would.
Mod.
Oh, yeah? Why? What's so attractive?
I would Anthony.
Him?
I listen to Anthony every morning. I love him.
Why are you so attracted to him? Why would you get between the sheets with him?
Between
I love him.
The
his
sheets.
Personality turns me on.
Oh, yeah? Does his voice turn
yeah,
you on?
Yeah, his voice turns me on.
What
you,
about
your
face,
boy?
His body?
And you're gay.
Yeah, you think I'm gay?
You're gay, I have no doubt.
Oh, yeah? Yeah. Let me tell you something.
All right, here it is.
I think you're pleasuring yourself to Anthony's voice.
You think so?
You're
well,
jacking
I'll tell you
it.
One thing.
Yeah.
Jack it to me,
wait,
you
let,
fruit.
Let him
no,
not comment.
Right now, I really am, but I'm not pleasuring myself to Anthony. I'll tell you one thing.
Mm. All
right. But I am in my birthday suit right now.
Birthday suit.
I told you, Anthony. He is.
I know. He's. Ugh.
His birthday suit.
Yeah. When was the last time you got laid? When was the last time someone came on your face?
Is that your opener?
Really?
Is that what you open up with when you walk up to a girl and
you must have
I
a hell of a drug
someone
you
came
know.
On your face?
On your show, man.
Not on my face, on my chest.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
She's got big ones, Ian.
Yeah, you have big ones.
Yeah, she's got big ones.
Are you bigger than Paris Hilton?
What?
I think she's gone.
Name dropping
gone.
Again.
Yeah.
So he's got to name drop the Hollywood elite.
Give me one more chick on the phone.
No, I'll do whatever the fuck I want.
Look,
who the fuck are you?
I'm your guest today. Where's Norton, by the way?
Who are you?
Norton. I forgot about that. Where's Norton? Norton is on a plane going to Cleveland to do a hilarious comedy show.
Oh, this guy Jason wants in. Jason in El Paso. Jason?
El Paso.
No. The weight of what I had just fucking went away. While I've been on hold, the Open Anthony fans are the best. I had to reload the Wikipedia page. Wiki it. But it's got, it keeps changing. It's changed like three or four times while I've been on hold. It started off by referencing that Ian Hopper is a douchebag Canadian, which just got removed. And they also just took off his preference for, I think, analingus and having balls across the face. But it just got edited right now, like I said, like the third or fourth time.
Oh, wow. Douchebag.
Keep changing it, man.
Google it.
You know,
Google it.
At least you're...
Wiki it.
You know, the fact is...
You're paying homage to me today.
Wait, you're a regular correspondent for Court TV? By the way, it's not even called Court TV anymore.
I used to work for Court TV.
Oh, well, how come it says a regular correspondent?
Because I used to do a show called, I think it was Hollywood Crimes or something, and they used to get me to do a lot of stuff for them.
Oh, did they?
Really? Yeah, of course.
Blowjobs.
I'm not like you, dude. I don't spend my whole day with one hand on my cock, one hand on my keyboard, you know, creating publicity about myself. I'm living life, dude. You're frustrated. You're on your fucking computer all day. You're probably Googling me all day.
Yeah, that's
and you're probably doing all these posts. But that's cool.
Well, Ant's going to comment in a second, but we got the great Charlie Parker on the line.
Oh,
Charlie!
Wow.
Hey, Birdman.
Charlie.
Fuck you, Ian. You blew off John Coltrane. Sing a fucking melody, you piece of shit. Cut.
Hey, dude. Let me tell you something.
You put on a record, you piece of shit.
You know
what? Melody.
You're poetry in motion, dude. And I respect you.
Culture, fuck you.
It's freedom of speech.
Sing a melody.
Yeah, let me tell you something.
He said sing a melody.
Are you jacking off while you're hearing my voice?
Where's your saxophone?
Yeah, is your hand right now between your legs while you're hearing the greatest harmony?
Where's your saxophone?
My saxophone ain't with me, man. I'm on assignment here.
Where's
assignment? I'm going to bring in that horn.
Where?
To the studio with my band, the His Highness band.
When? The His Highness band. Get the
fuck out. Ian, you don't have any Charlie Parker?
I love Parker, man.
You don't know the first thing about Parker.
Parker was a master of the blues. He took 12 progression blues chords and did what no one else could do with them. He was so melodic, every note counted. Now's the Time is one of my favorite songs ever.
Yeah.
Sing it.
Yeah, play Now's the Time.
Sing it. Hum it. Do something with it.
Well, now's the time to hang up on this motherfucker.
Dude, I'm on a different time zone than you, man. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I'm not about to sing for my supper here.
Well.
Yeah.
All right. You know, I gave you two anthems, dude.
Unless his supper comes
Anthony's
out of a cock.
Anthony's going to go to bed tonight playing the repeat, hearing me sing that Russian anthem, man.
Well,
he'll be all alone in his bed.
That's what it is.
Having the most wildest fantasies, but that's cool.
How about
that's who I'm thinking about. Right, Ian Halperin.
We got to end this on some kind of up note. So could you give us a little more of the Canadian national anthem or the Russian national anthem?
Oh, man.
Not just one stupid line.
Dude, it's so early
Sing us
in
out.
The morning.
Sing us out with something. Sing
I'm
us out.
Performer,
sing us
I'm
out.
Like,
sing us out.
Has been performers. They
okay,
fuck it.
What's next?
At night, the crowd.
Okay, fuck it. What's next? Sing us out.
Time is the essence of life. Time's the essence tonight. Amid visions of light, a long February night. Hipster pants, magical mystery prince that dance.
Go home and get your fucking shine box.
Oh, my reigning one-way queen, straightaway side parted main.
Wow.
His Wikipedia is insane.
it's just going crazy. People are just fucking with it.
After it just says he's a regular correspondent for Court TV, then the rest of his bio is Ian's sexual preference was questioned on the Opie and Anthony satellite radio show on February 25th, 2010, when Ian asked some male callers if they'd rather sleep with him instead of one of the hosts, Anthony. Ian is also known for his fondness of analingus and the feeling of testicles across his nose. He is the self-proclaimed king of the Jews and has personal ties to Angelina Jolie. Google it. He has been known to do things, but he can't tell you about them or prove anything because he's undercover. Norton. When trying to impress women, he often uses such gems as, I'll prove to you I'm not gay.
I'll prove to you I'm not gay.
He is blowing me as I type this. He also likes to talk to me.
It's crazy.
He also likes to talk to men to see if they are jacking off. He is a fucking coon. He called it the Obi Anthony show on February 25th, 2010.
He let
the host know he was calling
nude
and masturbating.
What? My fucking stomach hurts.
And masturbating to the sound of show host Anthony's voice.
Sam's actually crying. That is fucking hysterical.
Sam's fucking crying.
Oh, the listeners
rule. My
fucking
gut hurts from laughing so hard.
The fucking listeners
and
rule.
Look at Sam's you know, face. Because you know that people are going to copy and paste that, and there's going to be our listeners for the rest of the day. Every time that gets deleted, somebody's going to be adding it again.
Oh, yeah. Kurt Love. Thanks, man. Funny.
He's blowing me as I type.
That is fucking funny.
Oh, fuck.
Fantastic.
Oh, that's a good fucking laugh right there.
Well, what a great call from Ian Halperin.
Some update.
His Highness.
Oh, His Highness.
Update series Wikipedia. Ian was once seen jacking over Rock Hudson's grave. And it also says, well, honest, he also has a voice that sounds like he is trying to talk with a stuffed up nose while performing funny shit. And another fun fact from his bio is he also allegedly had a threesome with traffic girl Joe Nicolini and another guy.
And another guy.
Was that alleged?
Allegedly.
Yeah, allegedly.
Allegedly. It's, but it's Wikipedia, so it's got to be true. Yeah.
I would put it on a bio if he were coming in.
Yeah, of course. Everyone goes to Wikipedia to find out stuff about people.
More importantly, we found a girl that would actually fuck Brian Dennehy.
I know. That's, I think out of everything, that's the most shocking
thing. Can we call Brian's people immediately? Yeah.
He'd probably be very excited to hear that.
Oh, my God. My fucking God.
Well,
it actually fucking hurts.
That guy just, I mean, I think we've all felt that building over the last couple of times he's called.
He made a movie called His Highness Hollywood. This movie is about a young bear named Steve C. from Yellowstone and his erotic travels from Milan to Minsk in his Prius. Along the way, he meets E-Rock, a kindred spirit who, like Steve, loves to stuff his fat face. He also meets Ted Sheckler and Ted's crappy game. Crappy gay movie emporium. It is revealed later on that Steve became gay due to being babysat by Uncle Paul. Uncle Paul isn't really an uncle, but rather a friend of Steve's father. In the end, Steve approaches the three wise men, Greg, Tony, and James, who repeatedly smack him around until they find he likes it. He eventually dies when he slips in a puddle of AIDS and falls, impaling himself on a giant black sex toy. It is a suspected autobiographical story of Ian Halperin.
I swear to God, I think you gotta stop. It hurts.
He was once found in a park with a saxophone.
Don't say anything.
In his rectum.
Holy shit.
Oh, fucking hey, man.
Shit.
It's just
all on Ian Halperin's Wikipedia.
Yes.
Wow.
Whew.
Holy shit.
I know, I need a breather.
Ian Halperin was mostly known in Canada for being the only man in Ontario capable of fitting 21 cuts in his mouth at the same time.
The only one, huh?
pounding him.
During his record-breaking try, Ian was also reportedly jerking off two black men at the same time. He was later... rushed to the hospital for what was diagnosed as extreme ejaculate consumption. His stomach was pumped for 17 hours, though doctors The doctors admitted they only made a dent in the reservoir of semen residing in Ian's stomach.
Well, that is Wikipedia, huh?
Holy shit.
On Ian Halperin's Wikipedia.
Sam is crying.
Oh, my God.
You're actually crying from reading that.
Hard. That's just fucking funny. I suggest you read it. It really is funny. They keep deleting it,
but it keeps going back.
Yeah, yeah. Believe me, they will just keep fucking with him.
Whew. Holy shit, can we break?
Yeah, that was...
Thank God the computer just crashed, because otherwise you'd be here all day.
I know, we just keep reading it.
It really crashed?
Yeah. Yeah, that's what happened. We'll reboot it.
We'll update after the break, though.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, and we got a couple more tracks from the We Are the World song that will be officially done tomorrow. A lot of work has been put into that damn thing.
Oh.
Featuring all the people you know, love, and hate from this radio show.
Hey, I'm on Red Eye tonight, too.
I'm
on Red Eye on Fox.
Can we talk about how your dress shirt has been making me uncomfortable the entire morning?
Yeah, I just like wearing my TV clothes.
I know it's my problem.
I wear my TV clothes on the radio.
And came in with his TV clothes, and it's just making me very uncomfortable. I know it's my issue.
That way I don't have to pack as much.
Yeah, but can't you just bring it in on a fucking hanger or something?
No, that's a pain in the ass. The thing is, I'm here for a couple of hours at most, and then I go and...
Boy, ain't that the truth.
Then I just... Yes. At most. And
even
then,
though we're here 5 hours, you're here for about two, but goddamn, it's a good 2 hours.
Then I hang the clothes up. It's a good 2 hours.
It's a terrific 2 hours. No one's going to argue that. You've been on fucking fire today.
Started with that
goddamn mustard thing.
Oh,
no,
fucking mustard.
Let's be honest with each other. No one's doing better radio than this. Simple as that. No one.
We rule. Google it.
Aren't you glad that we don't have any big offers out there or big fake offers out there that we could obsess about for 2-3 weeks straight? Aren't you glad we don't have that going on in our lives?
Listen to us. We say we're great.
Yeah.
That was a quote I heard.
Yeah. That's when I know we're getting under his skin, which makes me really happy.
That was a funny one.
I'll go listen to them. They say how great they are every morning.
They talk about how great they are all the time. Yes, we do.
Yes, we do, because we know it's true.
Let's.
And we don't need Artie to do it.
Why don't you look?
Oh. Hit that, Travis.
Thanks for calling the Opie and Anthony FU line. Here's the latest batch of FUs.
You have 6 new voice messages. First voice message.
Yeah, this fuck you goes out to my ex-wife. Thank you for ruining my life. Fuck you.
Next message.
We'll give a big fuck you out to Club Soda Kenny. You have one fucking cookie a year, and it's not even a chocolate chip like a normal guy. It's a fucking Milano like some chick on a diet.
Next message.
This goes out to my UPS driver, Morris. Fuck you, Morris. Fucking go and tell everybody that we're not open on Mondays. We're always open on Monday. We're never closed on Monday. Now I don't get no fucking boxes on Monday, you son of a bitch. Fuck you.
Next message. This fuck you is for Anthony Cumia. I want to thank you for making my husband so paranoid of a home invasion by people of color that he went out and got a concealed carry permit. Asshole. Next message.
I would like to give a nice big F you to my drunk party too much fucking neighbor. You fat fuck tooth shit dick. I hope that night in jail worked well for you because it would have been a whole lot better than me performing some fucking dental work on you. You fat fuck tooth shit dick. Fuck you.
Next message.
Hi. I'm calling to say fuck you to me for pointing and laughing at my fellow truck driver for shitting the bed and calling the FU line. Ha ha! Fuck you, me!
End of new messages.
Call the Opie and Anthony FU line. 866-FU-LINE-1. That's 866-FU-LINE-1.
Thank you, and goodbye.
I gotta ask Sam if you got this one on Ian Halperin's Wikipedia page, which is being just destroyed right now. He has been known to use Variety magazine to funnel gerbils into his asshole.
All right. No, that's a good one. I heard that somewhere.
Yeah. I just refreshed it. And something I didn't know, which I should have prepped you guys with, is...
Fuck, yay pudding, sorry. I got a tweet, yay pudding.
Oh.
First one of the morning, by the way, Ant.
Oh.
Ian is also known for introducing interracial anal sex into pornography by taking the first black cock in the ass as he screams his idol's name, Anthony. Google it.
Google it. Google it.
That was quite an hour.
Some call. You know, when you have your... I've listened to a few shows on the radio throughout my years. Mm-hmm. And... usually when the entertainment reporter, correspondent, whatever, guy, comes on the show, I've never heard it go quite that way.
No.
That it went with Ian. Usually they talk about some celebrities, you dish a little dirt, you sound intrigued, and then you leave.
Mm.
It really turned into an hour of just bashing. Oh, is he the worst.
That was unbelievable, actually. Oh,
he's such a liar.
But they're also now...
I gotta say this. I still love him. I still love... I'm still in. I swear I'm still in.
Oh, God.
I'm still in.
Oh, I hate him.
There are two new reviews on Amazon for his movie.
Oh, wow, good. What a coincidence, because for how long? When was, like, the last review?
Can we do him a favor and buy him a copy? I got to play clips of this fucking movie on the show.
We will get a copy of it. We will.
Immediately, though.
The last comment was left on December 28th, 2009.
Okay.
Two have been left so far this morning.
Wow.
One from Kyle in Albany with the subject, utter garbage. 1 star. I watched this movie on recommendation from a friend. The man just spills out junk. I feel terrible for the honest celebrities that were given the chance to star in this movie. If it was actually a popular movie, it would probably ruin their careers. Save your time and money and avoid this like the plague. Another review, the subject is very disgusted, and it is by Amazon user Steve C, who says, this movie, quote unquote, was just a 60-minute webcam video of Ian Halperin touching himself to pictures of Opie and Anthony's show host, Anthony Cumia. Why would Amazon sell this vile garbage?
Oh, God.
Damn, was that good?
That was helpful.
Yes, that was helpful. Yeah. Mark them as helpful.
Yes.
Thank you.
They are... The listeners are great.
They're the best.
They're just fucking brutal.
In other news, we won't make a thing of it, but we got an update.
Thing.
Tracy Morgan has officially blown us off. Steve ran to him after Howard's interview, and he didn't want anything to do with coming on our show.
Yeah, like, apparently he knew.
Like, Steve actually was trying to get to the bottom of it, and he got a very vague, nah. And then Steve says, well, when are you going to be back in New York? And Tracy goes, I live in New York. And Steve goes, well, then come back and do their show. And,
yeah, do the show.
And he was like, nah, and then kind of, like, rushed off, so... I think we got to officially say goodbye to our old friend Tracy. He had his book out a while ago. He didn't come in for that either.
Yeah.
I don't know what that's about. It's just an update. It's too bad.
Oh, Jimmy's plane now leaves gate 30 minutes late.
I wrote Kenny and he didn't write back. So
well,
you think
they're probably
this plane ain't taking off.
On the plane,
but it left the gate.
But
so
they,
now it's going to be
no,
wait.
It says leaves gate 30 minutes late.
Right?
So they probably, you know, shut the door, and they're waiting to leave the gate.
Oh, my God, Jimmy's going to be out of his mind.
I know.
Well, I don't want to say it, because there's a lot of people that are looking forward to seeing Jimmy. Well, we'll give you an update tomorrow. Looking forward to seeing Jimmy at House of Blues in Cleveland. I'm thinking this is the scenario.
Yeah.
They're trying to go for it.
Can't they? Yeah.
But they're not going to be able to go for it. And Jimmy is going to be out of his mind as he sits on that runway for a few hours.
That's the only reason I asked for his flight and stuff. Yeah. I asked Kenny, and Kenny gave it to me. I put it into Flight Tracker. Yeah. The only reason is so I could look at this and gauge how pissed Jimmy Norton is going to get.
This is how mad Jimmy gets. He actually got mad at the weather when he came in this morning.
Oh,
and me and Ann had to go, Jimmy, you can't get mad at the weather. The weather is what it is.
The weather's the weather.
He's like, why did I book Cleveland in the winter? the last 10 winters, it's been pretty mild. You know, we're finally getting a real winter in these parts.
Oh, my dear sweet Jesus.
I hope he takes off, but I don't have any intel from Kenny coming in. Oh, wait, maybe I do. Something just blinked. Hold on. Hold on. Kenny. Oh, boy, they haven't taken off. That
no,
means
they haven't taken
it just
off.
Came in, swear to God. What perfect fucking timing. Been sitting on the plane at the gate, waiting to de-ice. They are starting to plow the runways. Jimmy has got to be out of his fucking mind.
He's probably freaking out, like a little scared and everything.
Let me write Jimmy.
Holy shit.
Give me a second.
No, you take as long as you like. There's something really good on Pal Talk.
Oh, really? Boobies?
Oh, my God, yes.
Can I see?
No. If I turn it, then I can't see.
I'm married, not dead. Oh, Jesus. Mm,
yeah.
Yeah, why don't you, like, you know.
What?
I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Why don't you do your Ian impression?
Hey, can I show you I'm not gay? Hey. Can I show you I'm not gay? Fucking guy. Oh, my God.
What should I write so he'll get back to us? We want to give listeners... Shit. Listeners... Listen... your listeners... an update.
I gotta get a bigger fucking computer.
Here.
This little thing screen.
Bad.
Can only make this fucking thing too so big.
Hopefully Jimmy will be right back.
I need one of those big giant fucking Apple monitors. I'm just going to get a fucking plasma television and plug it in. Just so I could see Martha giant size naked.
Yeah. Let's do a couple more outtakes from the We Are the World. Not even outtakes, just raw tracks. Yeah. The song tomorrow on this show. When are we going to debut it? Remember MTV used to do the big, tune in and whatever?
Well,
Want some big-time production like, here it is, drums and fucking lasers and explosions. Let's make a big deal.
Yeah.
As we premiere this thing. Like go old-school MTV premiere.
We have to figure out which hour it will be premiered in.
Well, knowing us, we're going to want to play it right away.
Mm. It can't be.
But if we were smart, we would tease it for 2 weeks.
At least we could maybe until like...
I think we could wait till 7:30 tomorrow.
You think 7:30?
Let's get some over the top world premiere production to start it off. Because we got to show the world we're great.
We are the world.
Yeah,
we are the world.
We tell our listeners every day how great we are.
I know.
We do. Apparently, we do. It's been reported.
Here's Bobo.
Oh, great.
A raw track from Bobo that will be featured in the We Are the World song that debuts tomorrow.
This ain't my law. We are the children. We are the ones to make a brighter day. So let's start giving.
Ning. Obviously, Bobo will be taking on the role of Wyclef.
Oh, is that it?
I had to coach him on the Creole.
Oh, no.
But
did he pick it up?
That was it. That was him. That was him.
The sounds that
he made in the beginning?
Then I guess the answer is no. He didn't pick it up.
Yeah.
Correct.
I got an update from Jimmy. Unfortunately, not that bad. Sitting on plane, hopefully back out soon to de-ice. Now, this flight was supposed to take off at 9:40, 9:45 in.
Yeah.
So they're already, 45 minutes late almost?
Yeah.
Almost 45 minutes late already.
Now, it's going to take a while to plow up the fucking runway.
Yeah.
And then Jimmy hates de-icing, especially when they de-ice and then leave you in the on the runway for a little while. Because then Jimmy starts going like, we got to go back and de-ice again.
Yeah.
It's going to freeze up on us.
And I'm getting a report from Cleveland. Joe in Cleveland. Joe.
Hey, man. What's going on?
Hey.
Hey, I'm sitting about 2 miles from the airport, so let Jimmy Norton know that we're supposed to get 6 to 10 inches today.
No. Oh, boy. When is the snow hitting up there?
It's right now. There's like 2 inches on the ground.
He's not leaving.
They got to take into consideration landing.
Yeah. Oh, my God. Poor Kenny. Poor Kenny's going to have to hear it. Because Kenny doesn't even know. Kenny's sitting there like he's at a movie right now. He doesn't know.
Yeah, Kenny is...
You don't know the difference.
Kenny's like a dog when you leave him home alone. Right. And everybody's asked the question, like, do they have any concept of time?
Yeah.
Like when you come home and they're like, oh, my owner's home. It's like, does he know how many hours went by or does he just think 5 minutes? That's Kenny.
Yeah.
I'm on a plane. I'm sitting here.
And it's like 5 hours on the runway. He'll have the same face as if it just took off.
Doesn't even need food or water.
No, I'm fine. I'm good. There. How are you, Jimmy?
But Jimmy's biting the seat in front of him.
Yeah, to Jimmy, 1 minute's like, I don't know, 4 hours.
All right, here's the new update. Status delayed. Departure is now 45 minutes late.
Well, but they're already 37 minutes late.
Well, now they're saying it's 45, but they keep doing this. I've been through this so many times where it's like 45, and then it'll go to an hour, and then an hour 15. They just do in 15-minute increments to make you feel better. That's why this flight tracker is great, because you can just stay in the President's Club and drink, and you don't have to keep going to the gate. And then when they say it's like, oh, we're 40 minutes late. And then you're sitting in the President's Club, you get up, you go down to the gate, and realize now it's even later.
Mm-hmm.
So you just take the flight tracker and go,
oh, that is
I'm
awesome.
Good. Oh, it's so handy.
That's a useful app.
Handy dandy.
Okay, why don't we do... Oh, another track from Bobo.
We are the world. We are the children. We are the ones to make a brighter day. So let's all give in. There's a choice we're making. We're saving our own lives. It's true to make a better day for you and me.
You and me, babe. We are the world. We are the children. We are the one who make a brighter day. So let's start giving.
Oof. At least he got the words right, though. Bobo didn't even quite get all the words.
You're giving! There's a choice we're making! Gig!
It's really hard to continue radio after that fucking Ian Halperin.
Oh, I know. It's hard
Ian
to continue.
Halperin is just the fucking tornado came through.
We really... No.
A snownado. Yeah, but I want to. What if it's a tornado and a snowstorm? No. Then it's a snornado.
Snornado.
Yeah. What if it's a typhoon and a snowstorm?
Snifoon.
Why snife?
I would have went snifoon.
No, because that's too much typhoon in it.
But then snowfoon has the entire word snow in it, and typhoon is going to be like, what happened to me?
Snifoon.
You got to go snifoon.
Like you know something? You're right, because I don't like when they have the whole word
it's like,
and then part of the other word.
It's not right.
It's got to be a combo.
And I hate anything like workaholic, because it's got a hall, which is part of the alcohol. It should just be you're a workic.
Yes, that's true.
Because alcoholic is alcoholic, and then workaholic? Why? What is that?
It's not like you're addicted to alk.
That was actually me at NEW. I was a workaholic because I would drink alcohol as I work.
That makes sense.
But if people are workaholic, it's like, oh, I'm a chocoholic because you like chocolate and alcohol.
No, you'd just be a chocolate.
You'd be a chalk-ick.
Yeah.
Alcohol. Well, no, actually, chocolate-ick. Because it's the whole word alcohol.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're a work-ick. Chocolate-ick.
But then you don't know what they're getting
at. Cock-ick. If you're Ian Halperin.
Yeah. But then you know what you're getting at, though. Workaholic explains what it is.
But it's the alcohol part.
That doesn't make any
sense.
That
has always bothered me.
Now it bothers me.
Yes. Now it will. Forever.
Forever.
Yes, it will.
And ever and ever and ever and ever.
Yeah.
Frank Mir. Jesus.
Frank Mir, the super across the way.
Are we still friends with Dana White? Because this would have been a great day to get Dana White on. Did we try?
That's a Steve Carlesi question.
Who the fuck knows who likes this day to day? You're right.
That's what Bobo calls
it. We officially have to give up on Tracy Morgan.
He's an eat-ick.
That sucks. Kevin Smith hopefully will be here. He's not going to be here.
I think we've lost everybody.
Yeah, why though?
I don't know.
We still got Bobo.
We're the Titanic of radio. It's just people constantly are just getting into lifeboats and leaving.
We're the guys going down with the ship, though.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
good.
The classy guys.
It's a very small hole.
Yeah.
It's taking quite a while to sink, but we'll ride her down.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
Frank Mir was on a radio show. Give this fucking guy credit. Mark Madden's radio show. Mm-hmm. And he talks about Brock Lesnar. Now, these two have fought twice, as you know. Mir beat Lesnar with that leg thing.
The first time out, which was a bummer for everybody because we were expecting huge things from Lesnar. But then Lesnar came back and proved himself and beat the living shit out of Frank Mir. Well, I guess Frank Mir is hoping for another match with Lesnar.
A rubber match.
A rubber match, sure.
Ooh.
And he was talking about that on this radio show, Mark Madden's radio show.
Talk about the animosity between you and Lesnar. How deep does it run? How real is it?
Well, I don't think Lesnar made it in pro wrestling because of his acting abilities. So I know from his point of view, he doesn't like me, and I can guarantee you, talk to anybody in my family, it's a legitimate hate. It's been very motivated on my part, where his very being bugs me, just because I see that, you know, there's a lot of children out there that, you know, they look to athletes and martial artists as role models, and it just makes me cringe. I sit there and go, man, I lost this guy the second time around, and now people are out there going, well, you know, that's the way to be big, obnoxious, and angry. You know, I'm like, no, man, that's not right. So it's almost kind of like a, you know, just a viewpoint, you know, anger we have against each other, or everything I stand for, he despises and dislikes, and I can tell you, I truly do not like him as a person whatsoever.
Fuck that role model shit.
Yeah, I know.
That doesn't help anyone.
Why?
What does that help? Wouldn't you rather watch Lesnar just being obnoxious and out of his mind than someone that's polite and nice because he's trying to be a role model?
Of course. Role models aren't fun.
I fucking hate
role model equals not fun.
Right.
Because if you're having fun,
right,
then it's not good for the children because it's adult fun and you're not supposed to show kids that, so you're a bad role model. Fuck you.
Fuck role models. Mir continued.
I've realized a long time ago you're going to have fans that love you and fans that hate you. And I'd rather go ahead and say what I found, what's on my mind, than to sit there and come up with some PC, you know, the guy's a great fighter and I have a lot of respect for him. And if I don't mean it, then why is it even coming out of my mouth? Because who's interested in hearing that? You say the same cookie-cutter responses. Oh, who do you want to fight next? Well, whoever the UFC deems me, I just will fight anybody. I'm like, man, I've heard that 1,000 times. I want to fight Lesnar. I hate who he is as a person. I want to break his neck in the ring. I want him to be the first person that dies due to octagon-related injuries. That's what's going through my mind.
Jeez, I wouldn't say that too loud. Fucking Lesnar might hear that.
Oh, he'll kill this guy.
Right.
Oh, he's...
You don't want to say that too loud.
He'll kill him.
Oh, my God. That's not good.
Yeah. Exactly. I got red eye.
Yeah, let's get the fuck
out. So I got to, you know, get ready.
Skedaddle?
Doesn't... You know, it's on at 3 a.m. So,
Yeah, you have nothing to do until 3 a.m. then.
Shh.
Why don't we do like a marathon show today?
Yeah?
Yeah, we just keep going.
All right, I'll listen.
Why don't we turn this into a...
I'll listen to it.
Why don't we turn this into Snow Day?
Yeah, exactly.
I love Snow Day shows.
You know what they do on Snow Days? They close places.
You notice,
let's close the show.
I noticed no one's down the hall.
The show is closed.
Jesus, how do you get all these days off? Could someone explain this to me?
I don't know.
Half the fucking floor is off again.
I don't know.
What the fuck? How does that work? What do I talk to? It's all dark offices down there. Extremely dark offices. And yeah. I don't understand, though.
We have days off from XM. They just never kept track of them. So now that they're making us keep track of them, everybody's got 150 days off that they have to use before June.
150 days off.
Not like literally, but
how
like,
do you guys get that many days off?
Well...
When I was coming up in radio, I didn't even get Christmas off.
No, I mean I don't know. They had a certain amount of days allotted for each employee, and I guess nobody was keeping track of it when we were at XM, so it was never on the books. So it was on the books as us not taking any time, and so then we got here and they said you can't take off all that time. You have to do it by the books. So we contacted HR and they said, you know, you have this many hours, you have that many hours, and it equal to like 4 years worth of sick days that we have to take in a year or let them go.
It's unbelievable. I want some of those days off. Can't you guys give me some of your days off?
I'll give you some of mine. I don't believe in taking days off.
Yeah, right.
Steve, can I give Opie my days?
I'm going to have to take some days when that thing happens.
You get 2 weeks.
I ain't doing no fucking maternity leave. I'll take a few days.
You get maternity leave.
I shouldn't take maternity leave.
Travis took maternity leave.
Sorry, Travis.
Oops.
But you want to take those 2 weeks because then are an extra 2 weeks.
I'm not taking...
You get your 2 weeks and the sick days.
Yeah, but then everyone knows I took 2 weeks for maternity leave.
Just lie and say it was for sick.
Think about it. Guys shouldn't take maternity leave.
Well, it's technically paternity.
I don't have the tits.
He said Dave took maternity. He took a week for maternity leave.
Dave took maternity leave. Yeah, you know how embarrassing that is? To us old school fucking radio guys?
Steve's going to definitely take maternity leave.
You're going to take maternity leave?
Steve will take maternity leave. I took paternity leave.
Both maternity.
Yeah, maternity leave's a little...
There's no such thing.
Would you ever take maternity leave?
Maternity leave.
Oh my God. What the fuck is happening in this world?
I have sympathy pains.
You're trying to tell me that guys actually take maternity leave in this world now?
Maternity leave. They say guys put on sympathy weight now.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
I just said what they say. I didn't say anybody.
They're saying.
I didn't say who.
Some people are saying.
Saying Travis didn't put any weight on and Opie still looks good.
But yeah, that's why it was a big surprise when I announced my impending fatherhood. And you're saying, Sam, it wasn't much of a surprise with old Fatso over there?
Holy
mackerel.
I didn't say your name. I did not say your name.
Wow.
I didn't say your name. I didn't say your name. He's being physical. He's being physical.
Yeah, see, you could go to HR with that. I mean, if guys are taking maternity leave, then guys should start going to human resources, too.
He has got a meaty hand.
Cut off your fucking cock and balls.
Meaty hand. That smack did sound very loud.
It's very heavy hand.
Yeah, he's heavy-handed.
Wow.
Maternity leave.
Yeah, guys are allowed to take maternity leave.
Now all the guys that have taken maternity leave are trying to defend themselves by saying it's paternity leave.
No, it's maternity leave.
It's paternity leave.
No, it's guys who want 2 weeks off, so they take maternity leave.
Yeah.
Reading has a good idea. I'm not going to be here tomorrow because I'm taking a sick day for vagina sickness.
Do you?
I'm going to have vagina sickness tomorrow.
Vagina sickness?
Yeah.
You're having menstrual cramps.
You know that women actually take like free days off because they have a heavy flow.
A heavy flow.
Yeah, that's in the handbook too. When you work.
That's if you got to take that that other like pill that they have.
Midol?
No, Midol is just for that. It's like some special kind of PMS. It's got another letter in there.
Oh.
And it's really like super hardcore PMS. Mess, mm-hmm. Where they're just vicious and bleeding and fucking rah, like a fucking tiger.
Maybe that's why E-Rock was so cranky when he came back.
Maybe that was it. You think he was on his like rad period?
Yeah, I think he gets terrible periods.
Yeah. Yeah, E-Rock gets really bad periods.
Yeah.
You know, some girls, it doesn't affect them that much at all, and other ones are curled up in the bed crying from pain, and then other ones are just bitches on wheels.
Yeah, migraines and heavy flows.
Heavy flows and neck pains.
Yeah.
He's getting muscle cramps. Pains and cramps.
He just complains about his cramps.
E-Rock's period is very heavy.
It's so heavy.
He has a bad period. He's got to start taking Yaz.
Yeah.
It might fucking make him feel better.
Where's Shamu so he can defend himself?
Shamu.
Is Shamu going to come down?
E-Rock takes daily birth control.
Yes.
To maintain so he can keep himself regular.
It's not even for birth control. It's just so his period. It's regular and it doesn't affect him as much.
Because he does have an irregular period.
Yeah.
Are you saying that he takes the morning after pill? How many abortions has E-Rock had?
Yeah, he takes the morning after pill.
E-Rock has definitely taken Plan B on occasion.
Yeah, Plan B. That is Plan B.
Here comes E-Rock. He's going to be so mad.
Hey, E-Rock. How you doing, E-Rock?
He gets so
E-Rock.
Mad.
E-Rock, we're basically saying you might be a woman.
Why are you
with
so
a heavy flow?
We're thinking that every so often, every month or so, you know, you get a little cranky. It might be your period.
Why is everybody getting mad at me today?
Nah.
Maybe well, that's what Sam said.
Yeah, well, Sam spews a lot of shit.
Yeah.
I thought it was. Maybe I was wrong.
Nah, I think you were wrong.
You don't need a maxi every so often?
Nah, maybe just a little hungry.
Oh, well, yeah.
A little tired.
He does get hungry.
But not cranky.
He gets hungry a lot.
Yeah.
What did you eat this morning? You're on that diet still, hopefully?
We only have a half hour left of the show.
Oh, shit. Oh, fuck.
What'd you just throw away?
Something Sam didn't need.
I don't even know what it was.
I think you just threw your phone in the garbage.
Oh, well,
I had one of those light yogurt muffins.
Activia? Just have some Activia. You know, it makes you shit.
A nice orange cranberry muffin.
Oh, is that good? Where do those rank? They're a little fatty, right?
Where'd you get it?
From
if you say Starbucks, I'll laugh.
No, no, from Lenny's, the sandwich place.
I mean,
those muffins are kind of.
I don't want to bore people, but it's
97% fat free
yogurt.
Yeah,
well, that 3% is pretty big.
And now you're just nitpicking.
I'm not even doing. If you really want to get into muffin discussions,
no, usually the muffins are really bad, but. Like I don't.
Did it taste good?
It was delicious.
Then it was bad for you.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially muffins.
He's still knocking back half a dozen diet sodas every day.
Oh, fuck.
Oh, Jesus.
Don't flick that rubber
band.
Delayed
again. Poor Jimmy.
Yeah, they're up to an hour delay.
Yeah.
They are not taking off. Because as they keep delaying, the snow is really starting to pound away.
The snurricane
is starting to happen. Anthony, we blew off this I can't even. I'm tired.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, Bruce has a comment on the Frank Muir thing, which is a very good point. Yeah, we should have made this point, is what I'm saying. Go ahead, Bruce.
Yeah, how can you say Brock Lesnar, I hate him, he's not a good role model for the kids, I hope I break his neck and he dies.
Yeah, you can't say that in the same sentence if you're trying to come across as a role model. You're absolutely right. And then says the most outrageous thing ever said by an MMA fighter. So, good point there, sir. All right, why don't we go home? Ant's going to be on Red Eye, so make sure you DVR that that fun show.
3 a.m. on Fox News.
Now, tomorrow, I hope the snow doesn't fuck this up. Because tomorrow on the show, Mick Foley's going to come in, hopefully, possibly with his wife, and possibly with his porno he made
his
with his wife.
His sex tape that he made with his wife.
Right.
That I guess he's very, seems to be very proud of.
He said that he had to get his wife's, he had to okay it with the wife.
And? She said no?
No, we have heard nothing yet, so I don't know yet.
And Kevin Smith tomorrow, or Sean William Scott, or...
Yeah.
Wait, did I misrepresent that? You ran into Tracy Morgan? We'll end with this. Steve did run into Tracy coming out of Howard's area.
How is Tracy? From running into him.
Where's that fucking rubber band?
You so didn't have to explain that.
I know.
But that's okay. Just in case people out there didn't get the fine fat joke.
No, because he said he started talking about how it's Tracy in that sense.
Well, that was good.
Fucker.
Oh, my God. You walked right into that.
Said hello to Tracy as he's walking out. He has a sex toy in his hand. And I said, hey, Tracy. He remembered me, knew who I was. I said, so how long are you going to be in town for? He said, I live here. I said, oh, well, why don't you come down and do O&A? No, I'm done with media. I'm like, what? And that was not, it.
We're media, yes, yeah, but we're also...
That yeah. was, it was yeah. sort of this ambiguous, nah, very smiley, friendly, and then he walked away.
Nah, man.
I don't really know how to interpret that.
But then you say, hey, you know, he says, I live in New York, and you say, well, then come back.
And yeah.
Said, no,
yeah, and, yeah. And it was an open invite that I said, well, come on and do the show. It wasn't, you have to do it right now. It was, come on back and do the show. Nah, I'm done.
Oh, well.
I don't really know what that meant.
Yeah, remember plugging gigs and stuff like when he's just... He was off of SNL, didn't have a show. He was just doing stand-up.
And we helped him out.
And it was filling up, putting some asses in them seats for him.
I know he doesn't really need our help right now, but it's kind of it's common courtesy for the days when we were there helping you out.
That trick never works.
Mike Wayne in Texas on my Twitter writes, does E-Rock feel bad for killing his trainer? See, because... You're working out, and then the top story is the SeaWorld story.
The Shamu thing, the whale.
I get it.
Oh, okay.
All right, we're going home.
Yeah.